And now we come to you live from the InfoWars News Center, deep in the heart of Texas, now under FEMA Region 6 occupation. World government is openly being announced. Nations across the planet are struggling, from Australia to the UK to the US, to get out of it. We have a bunch of key guests and intel today. The 2016 campaign is on fire. Trump is coming out against crooked Hillary like never before. She is in political hot water. We've got Obama stumbling around, can't even find words to go after Trump. The enemy is off balance. I'm telling you, it's a spiritual tipping point moment. First, a John Bound report that is key.
So many people around the world lack this freedom. We should never take that for granted.
The FBI will soon be legally reading anyone's emails without the disintegrating protection of the Fourth Amendment or the issuance of a warrant. Just for the record, the Fourth Amendment states, "The right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated, and no warrant shall issue but upon probable cause, supported by oath or affirmation, and particularly describing the place to be searched and the persons or things to be seized." As it stands, in order for your emails to be searched, currently a FISA court order deemed essential to the protection of national security has to be authorized. However, the FBI can plunder your phone records with a national security letter. But after years of whittling down the Fourth Amendment in the name of the CIA-backed and globalist-engineered war on terror, the Fourth Amendment will soon be DOA. Zero Hedge reports, the 2017 Intelligence Authorization Bill is used to fund the intelligence community, set policy, and authorize resources for intelligence purposes. The 2017 Intelligence Authorization Bill grants the FBI the authority to obtain Americans' email using only a national security letter, meaning it will now be able to access email without a court order. In 2010, the Electronic Frontier Foundation filed an amicus brief attached to a civil criminal suit in the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals. The appeals court ruled in the U.S. versus Warshak case that the government must have a search warrant before it can secretly seize and search emails stored by email service providers. Closely tracking arguments made by the EFF in its amicus brief, the court found that email users have the same reasonable expectation of privacy in their stored email as they do in their phone calls and postal mail. On Tuesday, May 24th, Senator Ron Wyden of Oregon said, "This bill takes a hatchet to important protections for Americans' liberty. This bill would mean more government surveillance of Americans, less due process, and less independent oversight of U.S. intelligence agencies. Worse, neither the intelligence agencies nor the bill's sponsors have shown any evidence that these changes would do anything to make Americans more secure. But the suck-ups inhabiting our nation's capital have other ideas."
But because we all rolled up our sleeves and worked together, the bill before us today is an exceptional work product, and I'm very proud to support it. The IAA also addresses key strategic questions that we have been asking over the course of the year. First, are we focusing too much on the threats of the day at the expense of the threats of tomorrow?
I'd also like to thank the staff on both sides for their hard work on this year's Intelligence Authorization Act, or the IAA. I also appreciate the opportunity to stand here in support of this year's bipartisan IAA. Now, we ask a lot of our intelligence community when it comes to collaboration. When they collaborate, they best keep us safe. And what we have done today is we are sending to the floor a bill that reflects our own collaboration and shows that what we expect of them, we can also deliver to the House floor.
2017 is shaping up to be the year Big Brother begins secretly hauling in the enemies of the emerging totalitarian state based on their private and once protected correspondences. Just another federal alphabet agency given, yet again, powers that don't exist under the American Constitution and Bill of Rights. John Bound for InfoWars.
I tend to say this all the time when I start the broadcast, but man, is it true that global government is happening just like they said it would, with engineered crises, collapsing borders, disintegrating family, dissolving rights, imploding prosperity, metastasizing mental illness, rampaging wickedness and evil, with the world ruled by openly corrupt, slouching tyrants, drunk on the blood of the innocents. We have a planet with leadership that is asleep at the switch. They're busy stealing and robbing and engaging in every form of corruption you can imagine. And they're busy trying to keep the public dumbed down and distracted so they can stay in control. But they're not in control of themselves or the byproducts of this system they've established. It is incredible. Now, I'm going to get the clip because he gives like 2 hour long speeches. But I was watching Fox News this morning while I was working out at about 9 o'clock. I worked out late today and I was about to finish up, and they played a clip about a minute long of Trump. And if he has that attitude and if he has that spirit, he will dominate this election and win for sure. And it was the same spirit of where he points to the sleaze ABC reporter and he says, we've gotten the donations we said we got. We've given them. Here are the veterans groups. And you're a sleaze for implying we haven't done it when you know we've done it. And he's legitimately angry at these lying scum. Well, today, in the speech, and we've got parts of the speech up on Infowars.com, but it's not in those particular videos. He's talking about, she keeps lying about my foreign policy. When you can go to my website and read my foreign policy or go see my speeches I've given, and they send out to millions of citizens emails, and the media puts out propaganda misrepresenting what I say and what I stand for. These people are crooked. These people are out of control. These people are corrupt. And these people have got to be defeated. And it's not just calling her crooked or, you know, little Rubio or whatever, little Marco or Lion Ted. He needs to say these are organized crime scum that have hijacked the country, that have sold our weapons to Al-Qaeda and ISIS, that have given our missile secrets to communist China, and that are preying on the American people and put Obamacare in over America to shut this country's economic structure down completely and to bankrupt the nation while fleecing the people. I mean, Trump needs to completely take the gloves off. Every time he does, he goes up in the polls. And I love what I see. It's already hardcore compared to all these milquetoast politicians and pundits. And he's to shatter the illusion, because here's the big secret of politics. And there's many secrets, but this is the biggest, or maybe one of the top two or three. You can debate it all day long. But the real zeitgeist of how we're being controlled is the control of the zeitgeist. They put out fake zeitgeist so that the average person in Europe or the United States, or anywhere in the world for this matter, sits there and reads the newspaper or surfs the internet or watches television and watches this ocean of political pundits that really don't disagree with each other, because they're within a small area of the spectrum. They're loyalist Republicans. They're loyalist Democrats. They're loyalist Tories. They're loyalist Labor. They're loyalist Social Democrats. They're loyalist German conservatives. At the end of the day, the leadership are all basically meeting in smoky rooms because it's good for business. It's good to control things. It's good for the business of crony capitalism, but not good for the people. And they've got things pretty much sewn up, they think, until there's a total paradigm shift and people get outside the box. So to quantify this, it's very, very simple, but also very, very complex at the same time. And you don't hear this talked about in politics. You don't read this in books. This is just my observation. And the fact that my observations over the years, because they are from outside the box, but from a historical perspective, become many times the major talking points a week later, a month later, a year later, a decade later in the political culture. What I say, what I do, the ideas that I espouse are a cobbling together of other political ideas and systems and historical thoughts and philosophy, but they are specifically a fresh look. Now, that doesn't say that I've got all the answers or that, boy, I'm a big wheel. No, it shows that their system is so fake and so based on keeping you within a fake synthetic debate where you never realize there's a whole world politically outside of that. And it's there to prop up that idea of the facade. And everybody's probably nodding their head going, yeah, tell us something we don't know. See, you inherently already know that. I know that. I'm just on the air saying things that are common sense. But in a world of universal deceit, to quote Eric Blair, telling the truth is a revolutionary act. And here's the big secret. The people on CNN, on MSNBC, on NPR, and Fox News to a certain extent, they know that they're in this good old boy club creating a facade. They're hunting us. They're part of the, quote, ruling class. They're part of the predator class, at least they delusionally think. It's like going duck hunting and throwing decoys out in the lake. Well, of course you know you're throwing decoys out so the dumb ducks think it's safe and come and land. And if a duck could talk and said, hey, you're setting me up, you're putting decoys out there, that's not very nice, the hunter'd say, well, yeah, stupid duck, that's what I do. I mean, they'll laugh at you. You talk to a news reporter high level, you talk to a banker, you talk to a globalist, and you say, what you're doing is dehumanizing, what you're doing is enslaving, what you're doing creates a horrible world in the future. And they laugh at you and go, tell me something I don't know. You're never going to change it. Might as well join it and enjoy your life now. And it's that cynical attitude by the establishment is what ends up destroying our entire culture, our entire world. Because these people are walking dead. They know what's going on. They understand human nature, but they don't have that final piece to want to try to do the right thing and be honorable and build a larger continuum of humanity. But I'm digressing. I've got to get to the news. What I'm trying to quantify here is they deceive the public by getting the public to buy into the false system, even though some of the public is more sophisticated and understands that most of it's a complete fraud. Still, they sit up there and talk about, well, if she says this, she'll win, and if Trump says that, he'd win. To make you think that you win by comporting yourself into what the supposed polls or the supposed pundits say is a winning strategy. You've just given up your free will. You've just given up being original. You've just given up being outside the box. You've given up being an innovator, a trailblazer. You have, in a split second, comported yourself into their system, into their universe, into their little fake facsimile that's supposed to draw in everybody's attention, where the establishment sets the trends and the establishment sets the agenda and the establishment sets the fads and the establishment decides the culture. And then we see the culture they're giving us. It's living death. And they go, well, of course we're giving you living death. We're turning you off. We're ending your life force. We're ending your self-sufficiency. We're ending your survival instinct. The world's ours. We're killing you. We don't give our kids iPads, Apple says. But we give money to LGBT, so it's okay that we have suicide nets and forced abortion and 17-hour workdays, and the Foxconn workers' children live in metal containers. It's all right because Al Gore's on the board and he talks with a lisp. And it's all right because he acts effeminate and Nelly. But not behind closed doors. No, no, no. That's not how Al talks behind closed doors. See, it's all a fraud. And I know you know that, but we have to have the understanding of the complete collapse of it in our minds ourselves and disdain it, dislike it, hate it, not go, ooh, you were on Fox and CNN and MSNBC today, Alex. Ooh, I saw you in some movie. Did you know you're in this movie? No, I don't care. I don't care about any of their system, none of it. None of it. It's all fake the last 60 years. I don't want to follow any of it. I don't care. I don't want its laurels. I don't want its awards. I am divorced from it. I am separate from it. It's damned. And by damned, it just means on the other side of me. I don't see it now. See, it's over there. I'm free from them. I'm going to come back and kind of put a cherry on top of this and get to the big news. And boy, it's a big news day. The facade is falling. The technocrat social engineers are our mortal enemies. They admit they are. They're eugenicists. They are manipulating us with high-tech propaganda that has been developed for thousands of years, but now has been brought to a high science. But as a species, if we're aware of that, it's game over. But people have to understand, what you're hearing here from me is not my opinion. When I say something's my opinion, I will tell you it's my opinion. When I explain the global government planetary project to bring in a one-world religion and reduce the world's population by 80%, that's the official UN policy. Look it up for yourself. That is a fact, not an opinion. And you and I and all of us have to deal with that. So I just took 12 minutes in the last segment to say something I could say in 30 seconds. I said to the crew, I said, does that make sense? And Allie said, yeah, they use the media and political systems to manipulate us and deceive us. Yeah, we know that. I'm like, here's the big secret. But the big secret is one of their number one tools is to act like they actually set the parameters and then to have us opt into it and repeat what they say and do so that we think we're winners and we're intellectual. It's not intellectual to repeat talking points from Fox News or CNN in a controlled paradigm. We have to break with it and say it's phony, it's fake, it's fraudulent, it's sleazy, and we've got to build something new. That building is condemned. It's going to collapse. Not, hey, let's put some more paint on it. That's what I'm getting at. And we're reaching that point. In every metric, in every poll, in every study, in what you see on the street, on the surface, you look at it, you can see it. You look deeper, it just gets worse. And so when we come back, the big news. I'm not really good at starting the broadcast and saying, look at all this incredible stuff we're going to cover. I almost like a man standing on the edge of a cliff for 10, 20, 30 minutes. Don't even get into it because it's so over the top. I don't feel worthy to be covering this info. I mean, we should have the greatest minds. We should have the smartest people. We should have any thinking person should be fighting the World Government Project with everything they've got. Because this thing is not some kumbaya Star Trek future. It's really dark. It's really bad. And even those of us that are awake are just becoming complacent that, okay, they sell body parts. Okay, they keep babies alive. Okay, they're splicing humans with animals and growing them inside, you know, cows. Big deal, Alex. You know, so what? Okay, so there is a secret geoengineering program. Okay. And then I sit here getting more and more upset. I know many of you get more and more upset. We have to ask, what is it about us that we have our survival instinct, that we have our instinct to live, our instinct to resist evil? And I think it's spiritual. Like, I know it's spiritual. But if you really study it, what our genetics are, that's why they say, you know, in certain bloodlines, you get bad bloodlines, you get good bloodlines. You get certain family bloodlines that have murderers and killers or mentally ill people in them. You have certain bloodlines that have incredible musicians in them of every race, color, and creed. You have certain bloodlines that are idiot savants at mathematics. Certain bloodlines that lead revolutions for good. Some that lead them for evil. And my bloodline, as I get older, I realize, is like a book. It's running me. I'm not running myself. I mean, my spirit, my gut is making the final decision. but I'm pushed in the way of resisting this and can't help it and just burn with uncontrollable energy to where I hate myself that I don't have more strength to take these people on because I can see who they are and what they're doing and how they're lying to people and how they're hurting people and how they want to make people stupid and make them poor so they can rule them. And that's the ultimate sin in my view. Suffer the little children, because what you do to the least of these you've done to me. Better for a man to tie a giant boulder around his neck and throw it in the deepest ocean than to hurt one of these. And Christ isn't just talking about children there, but childlike people that are ignorant, people that are mentally ill, people that are retarded, people that have physical issues, people that are gullible and, you know, want to buy into the latest cosmology. When you sit there and you know the secrets and you use those secrets to keep people in an artificial state of ignorance and to control them, you have got God just waiting to tear you limb from limb. And you're not going to have to wait till you die. All right, when I come back, I'm going to get to the really big news. It's so huge. I'm going to get into 2016, huge developments in the Trump campaign, amazing clips that are up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Trump turns Obama into a stuttering mess. That's up on Drudge. We're going to play that video and that audio. Hillary says Trump a threat to the world. Paglia says zombie time at Clinton campaigns. Well, she's a zombie candidate for zombies. We are going to be breaking all of that down today. But you notice that there's a theme in the news the last month or so, and that, oh, Facebook censoring people. And, oh, Google's starting to do it more. Oh, and Apple's doing it really hardcore. And Twitter is. And anything right of Mao Zedong, I mean, Google puts famous Maoist, you know, on their birthday up on their front page, that, you know, that called for killing any capitalist or taking farmers off their property, you know, putting them in forced labor. That was last week. And of course, these are people worth hundreds of billions of dollars wanting, you know, telling us Mao Zedong supporters are great. It's because it's authoritarianism and they want to scramble reality. But you notice there's a theme. And that's, we need to get rid of free speech. And then they announced on Monday, oh, yes, any mention of race or religion, just period, will ban you. Or Facebook says, if you hurt someone's feelings or, quote, disagree with them, that's a quote, we'll ban you. Three strikes and you're out. And now the EU's saying, oh, yes, we're going to prosecute people. And they are prosecuting people. And so's Canada. I mean, if you want to say you don't think transgenderism exists, then that's your right to say it, whether you're right or wrong. So we're seeing the basic framework stripped. And I harp on this because Matt Drudge came here like Paul Revere last year, 9 months ago, and raised the alarm in this studio and said, I have been told we're running out of time. Next year, they're launching the project to take the First Amendment away. And then all other amendments will fall after. And now all Hades is breaking loose. It's happening. I mean, look at these headlines. Facebook, Twitter banning free speech to form virtual super state. Billions of people use Facebook. It's the biggest state in the world. That's the founder of the Pirate Bay. And he said Zuckerberg is the dictator of it. And he's one of the 125 members of Bilderberg. They're all the dictators over the big corporations and the systems that have carved up the world, and they've exempted themselves from everything they're doing to us, down to Zuckerberg having big fences around his house and buying up the neighborhood and building a bunker, and down to Google suppressing search results for the homes and the activities of Schmidt. But he says anything you do on the internet, you better watch it. There's another creepy statement from him the other day about, you know, we know everything you're doing. We know all your deep dark secrets. These people are flaunting it in our face, what they're doing to us. And they're so historically arrogant and ignorant, they think they can build something like this and it's not going to bite them in the butt. Now, We literally should have a drum roll. That's the Reddit CEO. We know your dark secrets. We know everything. Huffman stokes controversy with creepy remark. Well, these are creepy people. I mean, who wouldn't start a tech company or an operation and then want to make it about promoting liberty and protecting privacy? Instead, they've built the internet so it's based on not having privacy. And so the fraud, the identity theft, all of it. And then they come in and say, we need a global internet ID. They've been saying this for 10 years at Davos, but it's been leaked out of Bilderberg for close to 20. You can go back 20 years where we say they will bring in a world government, a carbon tax, a wellhead tax, a Tobin tax. Everything will be tracked by computers, even if it's off the internet. The smart grid, the internet of things, will surveil all and end any, quote, underground economies for total control. Then they can truly manage economies and control them and predict the future. And if you can predict the future in mass movements, in their own words, you can then put in stimuli and steer the future. Now we're giving godlike power to tech execs flying around on jumbo jets with 30 or 40 hookers at a time. These are not serious men, ladies and gentlemen. They are all partying upwards of 5-10 hours a day on record. While they build something that is an attempt at omnipresent godlike behavior. Talk about the Atlantean moment. Whether Atlantis was real or not, we're nearing that moment with the nuclear reactors and the fission fusion and the Hadron colliders and the cyclotrons and all the other secret stuff and the GMO and the genetic engineering and all of this craziness just out of control. Pandora's boxes, thousands of Pandora's boxes just open. And you got a bunch of CEOs flying around on jumbo jets where they admit the Google jumbo jet, they have a couple of jumbo jets, is just nothing but bedrooms with glass ceilings. And just you see all these gorgeous women packing on the plane. And I'm not jealous of the fact that they got all these gorgeous women. I'm glad that, you know, Google isn't into what the Congress is, little boys and stuff. But the point is they're running stuff that I wouldn't trust, you know, the archangel Michael to be in control of. And we got these guys in control. And that's just one small little example. You know, Clinton's flying around on the jet, you know, to the pedo island. You know, that's my point is these people are corrupt. They're fallen and they're playing with fire. And they get off with the fact they're playing with fire and say, we don't care if it even blows up. It does something horrible. At least we died trying to become gods, to quote Ray Kurzweil. I've got the quotes in my film Endgame where all these top transhumanists are saying, we're going to become gods or blow the planet up doing it. And they said, in fact, if we can't become gods, we're going to blow the planet up. That's one quote by them. We may just blow the planet up for fun just because we want to be satanic. That's what happens when you're that decadent. So, drum roll, ladies and gentlemen. Kit Daniels has this article up on Infowars.com. And it's gotten no attention. I've not seen it anywhere else, neither has Kit Daniels. It was mentioned in a Breitbart article. And Breitbart does a great job. We got the head of Breitbart coming on in a couple days. Or is it next week? This is so huge. And then I got the document, and sure enough, what Kit wrote in there is in there. He's got the screenshots of it. This is such a big deal. If they started taking the free speech worldwide, would anybody notice? If Zuckerberg met with the communist Chinese censors scores of times the last 2 years and openly says they're bringing that style censorship here, would anyone pay attention? If he called his users dumb effers, would anybody care, or would they just grovel? I'm not wanting to start a fight with Zuckerberg. I don't want to be kicked off Facebook. I know we're reaching millions of people a day there. But I have to because they're incrementally cutting off all the little people. And I'm not stupid. When they're banning thousands of libertarians and patriots and veterans groups and people that mildly criticize Obama every day, we're next. You know, back when we weren't so big, Google would say, you can't have a shopping cart. You sell the Obama deception. That's racist. And suspended our shopping cart. Just because you can't criticize Obama, that's racist. They still suspend it today. But see, they don't do it so much now because we're one of the bigger fishies. We have a voice. Drudge would link to it. It'd be covered in the news. It would cause a debate. It'd make me a cause celeb. But they are shutting little people down all over the world. Because let me tell you something, you're not little. Millions of people with their own blogs on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube and reaching people together. You're thousands of times bigger than InfoWars. hundreds of times bigger than Drudge. And you're able to set the real agenda based on what humans are really thinking and gut instinct and common sense and survival instinct and God's discernment through you. And they can't have that. They want Mark Zuckerberg and his controllers to set the agenda. They want the globalists that control Reddit to set the agenda. They want the people that run Apple to set the agenda. And so they have to start curtailing, because the agenda that the people have set is, we don't trust the media, we don't trust the system, we're done with you, we know you're corrupt and evil. So they're just weaponizing things and going to the extreme of, now have you heard the new one? Democrats are teaching their kids, no matter what race or color or religion they are, to say Donald Trump hates Jews or Donald Trump hates blacks. We have these videos coming up. And they indoctrinate their kids, and the parents sound in the videos, whether they be white or Hispanic, well, in fact, we ought to compile the two latest ones, like cult members. They're like, yes, good, good. That's like Emperor Palpatine. Good, good. They sound so snake, like the snake in the Jungle Book. And so, drum roll, here's the big news. Just the latest. Every day it's some new giant hammer dropping on free speech worldwide. EU proposes government ID to use the internet. Done, done, done. Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.com. And here is the document. European Commission, COM 2016-288/2, communication from the Commission. And by the way, the unelected Commission does the laws. The Parliament is ceremonial and advisory. Wow, this is a dictatorship. Only two countries that entered the EU got to have votes of now 23, 24. A few are provisional, might be 25. A couple got to vote. Oh, France, Germany, UK, you don't get to vote. And by the way, we make 80-something percent, 90-something percent of your laws, depending on the year. And now the commission, like the Organized Crime Commission, all seated with a bunch of Bilderberg Group robber barons. Communication. It's not law, it's a communication. The emperor has spoken. The God emperor has spoken. Like, let me read it the way they would read it, in the spirit of it. Communication from the Commission to the European Parliament, the Council, the European Economic and Social Committee, and the Committee of the Regions. Just like in China. From the Central Committee to the 67th Politburo meeting. The Commission has spoken. A self-appointed commission that commands through the barrel of a 7.6239 round. Hiding in plain view. Communication. I mean, imagine how this is how they communicate. Is that like a bill to you? No, it's communication from the Commission to the European Parliament, the Council, the European Economic and Social Committee, and the Committee of the Regions. The Regions, not the nations, the Regions. Online platforms and the digital single market opportunities and challenges for Europe. The single market. Everything under a market, under corporations, no votes. A global dictatorship under the eye of Sauron. And then we get into your article, and you have it all. In fact, we ought to even do screenshots of folks for this, not just, you know, the digital text. People love to see the screenshot. At least it actually gets them upset. So whatever gets them upset and gets them to know something's bad happening, we should probably screenshot this or add this video to your article, Kit Daniels, Infowars.com reporter. And it just says, oh, online ratings and reviews of goods. The government will decide and control and regulate that. That's the Chinese model where they, quote, give you an internet rating as a person on the web that even goes down if you can have a job. This is the mark of the beast. Buy nor sell. Not engage in the commerce unless you're part of the club. So, Kit, there's a lot. Kit Daniels, tell us about your article. It's on Infowars.com. It needs to go mega viral. I mean, I don't even see mainline, you know, so-called watchdogs talking about this now, because it's just a bum rush. They're hitting us with everything, the biggest assault on human liberty the most scientific assault the world has ever seen, undoubtedly. When I make that statement, I am 100% sure of it. And you ask, why are they doing it now? Because they're getting ready to implode the economy and launch big wars and try to start race wars and sectarian wars. I mean, they have got a blueprint. I mean, you can feel it in your gut. But I've gone from, in my spider sense, my sixth sense, my discernment, my spirit, from being, oh, get ready, God, to like now just feeling energized, because now I can tell it's on, folks. Any fears that I was ever misleading anybody and was ever exaggerating have just peeled back, and my confidence has spiked even more, because unfortunately I know we are in an epic battle, because when they shut down the free speech, they're coming for everything, and these people are bloodthirsty. Look what they do to Christians everywhere they're in control. Kit Daniels, InfoWars.com report. I want to say good job getting this out there. I know this just came out like a day ago, but I mean, where is this? Well, I mean, I don't want to be the one ringing the alarm most of the time up front. That is not a good feeling, you know, to use a Vietnam analogy where they just say for, you know, year after year, you're going to walk in the front every day. I'm like, hey, how about somebody else? Oh, good, somebody else wants to be in the front today. It's not that I'm a coward. It just doesn't seem like good luck. Kit Daniels.
This is exactly it. This is neo-feudalism. This is a way to tax and control the internet. They don't want Matt Drudge with influence, you know, giving this, spreading ideas of liberty on the internet. They don't want Alex.
Federal Elections Commission came out and said, go after Drudge last week. See, they're all exactly.
They want to turn the internet back into what television was like in the 1960s, where they only had a handful of stations and they controlled everything.
And I've not even stated, so I'm mad at myself, kid. I haven't even stated how big this is. And I've always said this forever. When they come out with the internet ID, that's to restrict you, to rate you, to ban you, to track you, to tax you. This is the end of the internet as we know.
I mean, think about it this way. Facebook and Twitter's already one third of the internet. Where's all the internet traffic going? It's going straight to Facebook. That's just like a TV station in the 1960s that they control, where they can control the narrative. They can control what's spread. They use PC suppression to
exactly.
You know, to destroy any competition to the government.
They're carving up the web now. Go over your article. I mean, you've got the subsections. This is devastatingly evil.
Yeah. One thing I brought to that really bothered me about this document is the fact that they're using, it says, the proliferation of online video sharing platforms of content that is harmful to minors and of hate speech. Yeah, but like,
they're going to mix soft porn, but they're going to leave all the big Viacom and Sony women shaking their rear ends. You know, and bikinis, that's okay, but absolutely, they're going to mix political speech in with porn and ban us. They admit it.
Yeah, but like I said on Monday, the EU is the ones that are deciding what is hate speech. And to them, hate speech is just anything that...
An unelected group of admitted communists and socialists working for above-the-law megabanks.
Yeah, anything that runs contrary to their agenda is hate speech to them.
You're not allowed to criticize the migrants raping women or they come arrest you.
Yeah. Or even if you want to spread, say, Austrian economics online, that's hate speech to them.
Drudge is right. They first are putting us into internet ghettos, and then after you're in a ghetto and dehumanized and made poor and everybody forgets about you and segregated, then you're moved to the electronic concentration camp. So now they're moving to the... I'm not kidding, folks. Go ahead.
And what really...
I'm going to skip this break, because you know, we're not going to have a show soon if this keeps going. I mean, we're in a Mayday emergency situation.
Yeah, on Monday, I believe, when I saw this article on Drudge, when I woke up in the morning... This Bloomberg article, but what really bothered me about it was how bad they downplayed it.
Oh, they sell it like exactly. It's real. Oh, we're going to, you know, anything cultural, racial, or religious, we're sorry. You're just going to be banned. Sorry.
It's like, oh, yeah, well, we're going to just make more censorship. You know,
and oh, the tech companies all just announced in the last 24 hours they're going to sign an agreement with the EU to let them direct. Oh, and Facebook already beta tested hiring former Stasi commanders. It's all seamless integration. They're merging the tech giants with the global government. The Asia-Pacific Union, through the TPP, merges the Atlantic Union, which is the NAU, North American Union, and the European Union. They are merging the three super states with the 10 sub-regions now, with 10 sub-regions per region, directly out of Revelations.
Yeah, what's really bizarre to me is the one world government they're pushing is an electronic super state. I mean, think about it this way. You said this on the broadcast a couple of weeks ago about how Facebook is transforming our culture. You no longer see national identities or culture because everyone's going on Facebook. So now you have what they call a global culture.
Which then is dictated by the technocrats. And let's go further. Can guys pull this up? I think it was like 7 years ago. It was an EU directive that they actually started moving new franchises. Aren't the Spaniards or the French or, you know, the lion rampant for jolly old England. That's racist. They actually say on the news, you know, don't fly British flags. They're racist in England. They're taking them down. And that's the government. I mean, I'm not joking. You can pull that up. Well, now they're saying don't have sports teams with national names. It's going to be the Tyrannosauruses. It's going to be the Dragons. It's going to be the Grizzlies. Seriously, that was announced. You can't even have a team with a nation. Then it's you can't have a family. You can't have a mother. You can't have a father. People think they used to think I was joking. It's all here, Kit.
Yeah, and think about it this way. English, the English language, it got spread by the English Empire. Spanish, same thing, Spanish Empire. Now what we have is the Twitter language, the dumbed down language of 140 characters or less. It's just spreading globally. That's the new
language. That's right. They tried to have that other language that George Soros' dad pushed for world government. Mm-hmm. And that failed. So now it is the emoji, dumbed down, best friend ever garbage.
Yeah. And think about it this way. People can't think intellectually anymore when the language is so dumbed down. They're only thinking on a grade two level.
I know. And oh, man, I tell you, this is so incredible. This is the global dumbing down. They admit the screen time dumbs you down. They admit Facebook, the way kids use it, dumbs them down. I mean, it could be used for good, but the way they've tailored it, it is to boil everything down, reduce language. We're now a dumb person of today will be a genius in 20 years, folks. And you want to be able to communicate with young people then. And we're not attacking the young people. There's a project to make you stupid.
Well, you can't communicate with them anyway right now unless you talk to them over text messaging, because people are so addicted to their cell phones and whatnot. It's just like a Philip K. Dick book. Everyone's already connected into this electronic
wirehead.
Network. Yeah.
Cyberpunks, they have target psychosis.
Mm-hmm.
And people get so focused on that phone and so interfaced with it, it is destroying their minds. You know, I let my children, when they go to a camp or go to a friend's house, have a phone. And they like to take photos and shoot videos. They're very creative. And I thought, you know, I'll let them have a globalist slave tracker system. I explained to them that it's an evil system, that it's bad. They need to understand it. But you know what? It's so seducing. I've just taken them away finally. And I'm just sorry. You can have a camera for camera, and you can make films, and you can edit things, and you can do this and be great photographers and do all these great things. But this is too evil, and it's too dangerous, and I'm taking it away from them. Even when they go, you know, to a friend's house or go on a hike or whatever, you know, you think it's a good thing to have that, but overall, it's so wicked in the final equation, it just can't be done. Now, getting back to you, Kit, let's go over the article. EU proposes government ID to use internet. This is the final key in announcements. This is the final weapon being rolled out in the arsenal, as I've told you for close to two decades. When they call for an internet ID by law to track you everywhere, and for over a decade, Microsoft has a software on all its programs for thumbprint to access it. Mm-hmm. Governments leak your data. Governments, it's always big banks and governments, cause the big data thefts. And their answer is, we got to go to a biometric face scan, thumbprint, handprint, or voice print integrated system. So now, oh, the TSA won't grope you. Go through this tunnel. Oh, but we're still going to grope you now sometimes, though. So, oh, you get special rights if you submit to it now. That's just to make it standardized and ubiquitous. Oh, the $150,000 Mercedes, it's already a driverless car. When you don't drive good, it takes over for you. It'll save lives. You pay extra to be a slave. You pay extra to be the first group to beta test it. And so they have the elite, like you know, Chinese empresses with bound feet and 4 foot long fingernails who can't feed themselves or wipe their own arse. That's the same modern version of this, where you think it's all empowering you and you have the latest, ooh, as a status symbol. And all it is the latest chains around your soul. I'm going to hold you over because you get me so excited. Your article's so powerful. This is powerful. Every point you make about how they're reducing us to the global Facebook language of gibbering idiots, where everyone's wearing goggles in a false reality, but Zuckerberg walks like a god bipedal with his pronounced canine smiling, the wolf amongst the legless, armless sheep. What an archetype. We're going to go to break. I'm going to come back with Kit Daniels with more on this. This is absolutely essential. Folks, I cannot put a bad enough face on this, but we need a bad face on it to wake up to it, to overthrow the facade in our own minds and realize we are being overtaken by a group of psychopaths that are building an artificial reality to insert us into it so that we're anesthetized and culturally numbed when we're put through the shredder. That's going to be done incrementally. But the final group will be the elites not controlled by the globalists. And you will wish later you would have joined me in the fight against these people. You've got the know-how, the capacity. You know I'm telling the truth, but you don't have enough faith in humanity to make a stand. You'd rather go play golf and go have sex with your mistress and, you know, go do whatever it is and just hope everything's okay. It's not going to be okay. Be a man. Be a woman. Stand up. Speak out. Do something. I mean, who is there? Matt Drudge talks about the technocracy and fights it. I do. World Net Daily, a few other groups. Donald Trump, partially. Briefly, we need to, for people to buy products. We have great products. Over 1,000 products at InfoWarsStore.com. Great nutraceuticals. Game-changing products. We have this new Alexa Pure Breeze air filtration system that just blows away anything close. $500, $800, $1,000 units don't do as good. We have all the ratings. Mainline, you know, institution sites. It's just unbelievable. Eliminates 99.97% of airborne pollutants. It's amazing. We sold a ton of these yesterday, so that's good. But the price is so low. Introductory rate of $184. That's 26% off. Again, we need to sell. We need to sell thousands of these, not hundreds of these, to be able to fund this operation just on a weekly basis. InfoWarsStore.com. Whether it's Hillary for prison T-shirts to exercise the First Amendment. Or Molon Labe to defend the Second Amendment, or whether it's X2 Survival, Shield Nation Iodine, or Vitamin Mineral Fusion, Fruit Punch Drink to be healthy, or Supermel Vitality or Lung Cleanse, just get in there. You owe it to yourself to have these products. And we need to fund this military operation. And we are a military operation. We're humanity. We're a desperate, instinctive, organic death throw, death rattle of humanity trying to get up on its elbows while the globalists are stabbing knives into us. So just fuel us right now and pray for us. We're all in this together. InfoWarsStore.com. Go there now. Larry Nichols is joining us. Joe Biggs has been out in the middle of zombie land out in California going to the Social Justice Warrior events where they try to shut down free speech on campuses. Incredible footage there illustrating the evil of these vile people. These anti-liberals that call themselves liberals. Kit Daniels has written a very powerful article. He's here as a reporter, so we're humanizing the story of the guy that is basically breaking the fact that the EU is just announcing what they're going to do. And they let the parliament, quote, have a look at it, but then they always do whatever they want. So the article's up on InfoWars.com. It's a way to tax the internet, track it, and kick you off of it. And they admit that's their plan. They're going to give you an internet rating. In fact, you guys printed that article from a few months ago where it was big news. Whenever they said, you know, the Chinese are going to have a, you know, internet social rating. Oh, it sounds so cute. No, it's a government approval to be online. And then the government with tech giants saying who you are, what type of person you are and labeling you. Well, they're going to say I'm a Nazi. I mean, what do they say about Trump? China's social credit. Beijing sets up huge system. BBC doesn't talk about how nightmarish that is. You've got the floor, Kit Daniels. Go ahead and break down this article and the subsections of what this dictatorship has announced.
Well, like I said in the article, it's the fact that not only are they going to be able to track what you buy by your online government ID, but what they also want you to do is be able to kind of track what you say to make sure that, you know, you're not spreading so-called hate speech or talking badly about a company anonymously.
This is what the Chinese government wants.
Yeah, and I also want to briefly point out that, you know, a lot of people online are already making comparisons between this and the Mark of the Beast in the Book of Revelations. And, you know, the one thing that the Mark of the Beast says is about the, I believe, the mark on your hand. Now, think about it this, you know, what's the EU going to do next? They're going to push for biometric ID. They're going to push for electric, you know.
That's what internet ID, that's how it's controlled. Exactly. It's biometrically.
And how they're going to do it is they got all these Muslim migrants come in the country with fake passports, fake IDs and whatnot. So they're going to. So that's what they're going to use. They're just going to false flag the whole migrant situation to say,
same thing. They flood us with illegals, then exempt them, and then make us thumbprint 20 years in Texas.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And kind of still on the same topic, you know, I was reading on a science, you know, these astronomers always wonder why the universe seems so desolate. Where's the life at? And there's always been this, what this theory called the great filter theory. Like there's civilizations, but at some certain point they collapse. And that's what really scares me right now, Alex, is I feel like humanity, we're going to hit this filter. Maybe that's why there's not any life that we know of in the galaxies, because you see, maybe they've had governments too.
And then, well, what happens is what makes a species great then creates incredible plenty. And then predator groups rise up.
The predator class.
That want to base it on being predatory, not on innovation. And then things implode.
Yeah.
Or they advance technologies too quickly. People get arrogant. and you destroy the whole system.
Yeah, and this is something that people don't understand, especially Bernie Sanders supporters, is the government does not produce anything. It's the people that produce the culture. It's the people who...
And just look at the supporters of socialism. They're helpless, stupid, dumb morons that think they're intellectual. They can hardly walk.
Yeah, and then they think that, well, if the government's not there, who can build the roads? But it's like the government's the one going out and finding subcontractors to build the roads. The government's not even building the roads. They're not building. NASA had all these subcontractors building all the...
And now they're trying to come out where the government does build roads. When they do, they can't do it.
Yeah, exactly. It just ends up being a zigzag.
French government couldn't build Panama Canal. The U.S. had to come in with private contractors. You know,
the only road the government can build is a road to serfdom.
Is that a Kit Daniels quote?
No, I just came up with it.
You are a genius. Tweet that right now on Real Alex Jones.
Okay.
Kit Daniels, the only road the government can build is the road to slavery. Because, you know, the public doesn't know, not our audience, but the general public, no, we have to dumb it down like Trump does to reach down and pull them up. We're not dumbing it down to make them dumb.
Yeah.
They won't know it's serfdom ish.
Yeah, and it's like the headlines and stuff. People accuse us of being too sensational, but the thing is, the public is so dumbed down, they can't even reach the truth.
This is sensational. They're always saying, don't be sensational. It's sensational when Microsoft and Apple and everyone say, we need an internet ID, the EU's leading the way, and they're beta testing it there for here, and all the new computers are coming out with biometrics, and your stupid iPhone and Droid tracks how much you walk and when you eat when you have sex.
Yeah, I mean...
little spy bots.
The physical...
These are what are the thing in Doctor Who that are going around to kill you?
It's like the Space Odyssey obelisk to me.
The Daleks, I just can't handle it. I mean, why do people want to go through this? And then you figure out the elite are a bunch of pedophiles? I mean, no wonder they want all this control. Kit Daniels, your article is so key. It's got to go mega viral. Congratulations on your hard work. If you study the 6,000 plus years of chronicled human history, patterns become very, very clear. It was once said that history doesn't repeat, but it does rhyme. Every mainline political scientist, mainline historians, concur with our analysis of the last 20 years. Humanity is headed towards a collapse event. And they codified that in 1992 at the Rio de Janeiro meeting into Agenda 21, a global plan for a post-industrial world. I am quoting from the document. Go read it at the UN website. I've made 4 films on it. If you're a new listener, I'm not just saying this stuff. And when Obama tells Africa you can't have cars, you can't have air conditioning, when he lands on a big jumbo jet with a red carpet and 15 airplanes and support and 1,000 support crew and $50 million a day or $45 million, whatever his average trip is, that is arrogance in your face. That is absurdity. But they are absurd on purpose to normalize bizarro world type activity. Not, hey, we're going to innovate cars. We're going to innovate air conditioning. We're going to innovate and have clean systems. No, no, no. They do those, but only give it to themselves. Larry Nichols is going to co-host with us for the balance of the hour. He, as usual, has big breaking news, former top insider with the Clintons. But the censorship is here, as he warned, as Drudge warned, as other folks that talk to big insiders have warned. And believe me, I've talked to him as well. They are telling the Pentagon things, and they are telling the military things that is absolutely making the brass, even down to non-commissioned officers and the intelligent special forces type operators. And everybody's intelligent in the military, but I'd say the military is more intelligent on average than the general public. But we have a dumbed down society. And there are a lot of people in supply or whatever, been there 1 year or whatever, don't know, you know, they're having a hole in the ground, just like there could be an auto mechanic that's stupid right next to a guy that's really smart. But the military is super awake, okay? Because they're being trained to take guns and shut the internet off and arrest people and take over legislatures if states don't go along. I mean, that's in the John Warner Defense Authorization Act of 2007. They've been gearing up for this for a long time. They've got civil emergency in Europe. They're funding Arab Spring. I mean, it ain't coming. It's already here. Just like we've been in a depression in most areas of this country. We never left the recession. And with Cook numbers, we got a 0.8% growth rate. That's probably a negative 2, according to all the experts that actually go off real numbers that were used up until the 1980s. So we're in an epic moment where our funny money is still buying stuff, but not like it was. And where the elites are headed to the hills so they can sit back and watch Rome burn and roast marshmallows in the flames. And that's how stupid they think we are. And then they come out on Monday, the top six tech giants, led by Facebook, who met with Merkel on TV and said, I'm going to censor the internet, hiring Stasi operatives last year to run the tattling to the police when people criticize open borders, and they come and arrest them under interpretations of hate speech. Now they've announced EU-wide any criticism of government, it says right-wing hate speech in the document. They mix that in with porn. Oh, yeah. Which they openly push. And this is from the communication from the Commission to the European Parliament and the Council, the European Economic and Social Committee, and the Committee of the Regions. And this is from the European Commission, and these commissions are what runs the EU. The Parliament is ceremonial, making it a dictatorship. And I've had members of the Parliament on. You can read it in the EU. That's why the EU could never be voted on, because you can't have it be voted on at the beginning, because that would begin to act like the votes were involved. This is hidden in plain view at a massive level, and this dovetails with China. And our article, Paul Joseph Watson, December 23rd, 2015, 6 months ago, coming to America. Drudge linked to this article. No one else cared. I'm not kissing Drudge's butt. It's weird to sit here with just not even mainline libertarian or conservatives or other groups getting what's happening, because it'd be too scary to report this is actually going on. Let's not report on Foxconn and suicide nets and forced abortions. Or mobile execution vans. That's too scary. That's too sensational. Well, it is sensational. Like Lenin killing 20 million Russians. Reality sensational. Pol Pot killed 30% of his country. Anybody that could basically write was killed. Because all they want is a bunch of Triggly Puffs and AIDS Skrillex running around. These social justice warriors who are dumber than a box of rocks and want to attack anybody who stands up for freedom. Coming to America, China introduces credit score for obedient citizens, a internet social score, and finally you'll just be banned if you criticize government or criticize corporations or anything. And then you read in the EU Commission document on Infowars.com what they say they're going to do. It's like the EPA says, oh, we have a month of, you know, public comment, and then we're going to do what we want, because Congress says we have that authority, even though Congress says you don't. And the Supreme Court rules they can just operate freely on their own and just run around doing whatever they want. It's called dictatorship. It's a bunch of crooks stealing power in your face and thinking you're too stupid to know it. And now they're telling you mom and dad's a bad word, and he or she's a bad word. And you know what? We can't have American flags or British flags. They're hateful. They're hurtful. And you read this thing. I want Larry Nichols to hear this. I want to talk about the free speech attacks. We'll get into all the other news, play a bunch of Trump clips we've got. This is so chilling when you read this. This is crazy. This is crazy what they're doing. And again, it's worse than just Obamacare, where it gives them a blank check. It does that as well. But it just says, we will decide, we will interpret. In the name of this, the name of that. And they say they're going to decide about online ratings, and they're going to decide what you can say about sites, and they're going to make you have an ID so you can be taxed and traced and controlled. They're going to decide. These are people arresting folks all over Europe that criticize the open borders. You wonder how they bring in 5 million Muslims out of war-torn areas, 80% of them, military-age men, and they don't bring out of thousands of migrants. They have less than 1%, we covered that yesterday, that are Christians, when Syria is 20% Christian, because they don't want them there. They want to bring people in to stir up trouble, rape, rob, and kill. And then when they do, they come in and say, we're going to take everybody's free speech criticizing this to stop the problems. And I told you they'd do that, and now they're doing it. Folks, Larry Nichols joins us. And, of course, he was a Green Beret and secret ops around the world. That's how he got embedded with the Clintons to be their handler, with the CIA's front group, the Dixie Mafia. He's the guy behind the Clinton Chronicles and so much more. And he's got a lot of big Trump news. I don't know how much of it he can say on air, but some very positive developments. Trump's taking the gloves off, and he wants to communicate to the Trump people directly today on this show for some specific reasons. I don't know how much he wants to get into this about, but all this is unfolding. This is accelerating, and they wouldn't be openly announcing all this censorship worldwide and here domestically with Facebook launching all these purges if they didn't have big stuff about to happen. So Larry Nichols joins us. Larry Nichols, God bless you, my friend. Obviously, I want to cover free speech a few minutes before break. I want to come back, give you the floor, get into the fact that you're the main source for these big news articles exposing the deaths, Vince Foster, the murders, the Arkansides, the rapes, the cover-ups, and Trump's taking the gloves off, so that's exciting. But thank you for joining us.
You bet. Well, thanks for having me, Alex. Sorry about that. Everything you just said is exactly true. And what's really incredible, Alex, you know, typically you and I talk about these things. Excuse me for this thing.
Listen, I should tell listeners he's battling cancer. He needs your prayers. He looks really rough. He's got a tracheotomy in right now, and he's tougher than a box of nails. So we love you. Go ahead, brother.
Well, it's not a trach. I just got an extra hole. They seem to think I need some more holes in me. But let me tell you, this is not coming from us, Alex. Now it's coming from other sources. But what is incredible, just as you had predicted, and I've said, hey, guys, it's out there, but isn't it amazing you still don't hear it? You know, used to, they'd say, well, that's nothing. That's Alex Jones or Larry Nichols or some of these nutbag sensationalist conspiracy nuts. But now all of a sudden it comes out by Reuters, other people, creditable people in the industries. And guess what? Now you just don't hear about it. Alex, do you realize they could be stealing the world right now? All that's on the news is this campaign. That's it. 24-hour news is 24 hours this campaign. And what is incredible, you got, bless his heart, a gorilla that was killed. That takes precedence over the information that's coming about the destruction of our financial
system. That's right. The top story is the gorilla for 2 days. And meanwhile, the entire internet freedom and free speech is being demolished. Europe has fallen. Even mainline news, you know, calls it martial law. And they're arresting people. They're arresting presidential candidates. I mean, just all hell's breaking loose. And all we're looking at is campaign 2016.
That's right. And folks, I'm going to tell you, you're starting to see some of the things that I said, Alex, a couple, 3 weeks ago right here. You're starting to see them start to manifest. You're starting to see them unfold. You know, the major financial players in the world, they've even got a name for it now. It's called not bailing out. They call it bailing in. And you know what their bailing in plan is? And I'm talking about the heads of these big five major banks. You know what their plan to bail in means?
Absolutely. They're going to bankrupt everything, claim you got to save the system, give themselves unlimited trillions, and then set themselves up with even more governmental power.
Giving themselves the money. They're going to take your money and claim they have to repatriate your money to help pay the bills, but they're planning to keep it for themselves. They're going to walk away from this thing so they think, and they're going to have all this money. Now, the joke of jokes is, if they'll look back in history, usually when the dictators take power, they've got all these cohorts that go with them. But you know what, Alex? When everything's said and done, those cohorts are the first ones to go, because dictators don't like people around them. They don't like people around them that have made it.
And that know where the bodies are buried, and that could use things against them in the future. In every tyranny that's taken over in planetary history, always the Quislings, the Minions, the establishment wannabes, the people that thought they were safe, didn't realize there was a dossier for a Knight of the Long Knives to take them out the minute the real hammer drops.
Absolutely. And folks, that's coming here. The only thing that I would say before we go break, Alex, is
I skipped it. It's too important. We're not going to even have a show soon if this continues. Everybody knows it. Hammer's coming.
Okay. Look, guys, listen to me. I want to say a message, if I may, Alex. Hillary, come here, girl. Look in my eyes, girl. Let me tell you what's going to happen, Hillary, me and you. Now, you're either going to have to go through me, you're going to have to go over me, but you're not going to be able to go around me. This is going to be a match of this is your life. And everything I know, and you know I know, is going to come out. So you better get right with Jesus, because your chances of being president of the United States that you've wanted since 4 years old, I assure you this day, ain't going to happen. Now, you know, Alex, with that, I'd say to Hillary, you know, you better start looking. If she would change today, if she would change today and start thinking about the people of this country, that would make a difference. But you see, she won't. She won't. Obama. Obama has successfully stripped us of our three branches of government. But do you know where that came from? That came from Bill Clinton. The first day Bill Clinton took office, ladies and gentlemen, please remember this. He fired 111 federal prosecutors the first day in office. Now, do you know who appointed the ones to replace them? Hillary. Why? Because, you see, they've got it set up. Obama does it. They got it set up to where, let's say you've got Hillary raping some woman downtown Little Rock, Arkansas. Well, if they control the federal prosecutors, who are you going to go to get them prosecuted? Then they came in and they have taken control of the Justice Department. They have now fixed it thanks to Bill Clinton and, yes, George W. Bush and Barack Hussein Muslim Obama. They have fixed it to where there is no longer three distinct co-equal branches of government, Alex.
And that's why everything they've got set up is to try to send in the military. If coalitions of states say no during martial law to go along with, say, arresting all the conservatives or the patriots, they're going to try to send in special ops to take over the state houses. But the special ops know they're being trained for this. They know it's a setup. The problem is there'll be big false flags blamed on patriots, kids killed, school shot up, you name it, to try to sell the idea. But I don't think that's going to work. I think the New World Order has bitten off more than they can chew, studying the waterfront. But unfortunately, the battlefront, the battlescape, unfortunately, though, Larry, correct me if you think I'm wrong, it doesn't matter. They're still going ahead. So this is like a juggernaut about to run into another juggernaut. This is going to be explosive.
It is. And I'll tell you right now, the whole reason behind normalization of Cuba. Now, I ran into the Cubans in Nicaragua. I ran into them in Afghanistan, of all places. I mean, wherever the Soviet Union used to be, they would send in Spetsnaz, Alex, and the Spetsnaz were the special ops like we have today. They would come in with their advisor Spetsnaz, and then they'd bring in the Cuban black hats. They were the fighters. They were the ones that did the dirty work. Now, 6 hours, 250,000 of those black hat Cubans could be in this country. 6 hours. Obama knows it. Everybody on the Joint Chiefs staff know it. Everybody that's working every day on the FEMA provisional government drawing board, the ones that do the games every day, they know it. So, yeah, we've got this big explosion because I do not believe, Alex, I refuse to believe that Obama, Hillary, Bill, anybody, I don't believe anybody is going to be able to take the United States of America soldier and get him to turn on the population. It's just not going to happen.
Well, listen, I concur with everything you say, other than the Cuba thing. And I know you fought those guys, and I understand that they just used them over there in Syria and all the rest of it. Mm-hmm. But I see the normalization happening. But that would unify the American people to bring in foreigners. But I look at all the La Reconquista propaganda that's been done in most of the country. If it was pushed from that perspective and as a leftist overthrow, it might actually work in certain sectors of the country, and then that's just a breakup of the nation. But do you think the elite would actually try something like that?
You bet they would. Look, Alex, this is what I'm trying to point out to the American people. Do you realize in this election so far, thus far in this presidential election, over half of the people that have voted in this primary have willfully voted for either an announced socialist or a progressive, which is another name for a communist in Hillary. Yeah, you know, they're looking right now. This is what's driving this, Alex. The elite see that they believe the American people are ripe. They think it's now. And the thing is, they got to do it now, because just like we know, this is our last election to where we're going to be relevant. They see this is the time. And if they miss this window in time, it may be 10, 20 years before they ever get this nation back.
History shows
the vulnerability it's in now.
That elites do wild things and do bite off more than they can chew. And I see them, the activity at 50 times what it used to be. And I see the color revolutions George Soros pulls in Europe and the Middle East. And I see him running things. And it looks like, you know, he's got wide body jets ready to get out of here in 5 minutes' notice. So you may be right. Regardless, they're trying to push racial division, cultural infighting, Larry Nichols. They're accelerating that. The Justice Department's accelerating that. How does that feed into this?
Well, what's happening right now, if you look, they've got the police in this nation to where every time they stick their head up and do their job, they're prosecuted, they're attacked viciously by the black community, Black Lives Matter. And so what they're being forced into doing is being forced into retreat. Look at Chicago. How many people this weekend were murdered in Chicago? I don't know, 40, 60, whatever. They're going to get major cities, Chicago, Dallas, Atlanta, et cetera. They're going to get major cities in a situation to where the people, Alex, the people, they're going to go to the federal government and say, dear God, the police can't handle it. Send in the government and protect us. That's what they're playing for, Alex. They're not playing. So that's where everybody gets it, I think, a little wrong. They think they're going to come in as jackbooted thugs, march down our street, and force us into submission.
No, it's done in the first wave, so the military thinks they're doing a good job, too, because they're good people. That's the first wave. Then the organizers, the socialists, the national security force that Obama talked about that should be just as big and strong as our military, it's in the next phase. So it's an incremental takeover. By the way, Chicago had the highest crime rate in the world last year. It's doubled that this year and is set to quintuple again. So clearly, and then I see articles every day, white racist police officers arrested people. Okay, or punched somebody. Okay, prosecute them. But is 20 black people killed in a single day or in a single weekend is by black people, is that important? Or is it the racist cop? I mean, that they then project onto all the police to collapse the police and collapse the city.
That's right. And then they break the backs and they break the hearts of our police. And the police withdraw. You know, hey, if you're a policeman and you're not going to be supported by the community to which you serve and protect, if every time you do what is your job, which is highly dangerous and puts you in very touchy situations, when you have to respond, that same community that you're trying to protect attacks you, not the people that you were protecting them from, the police are going to back up. And that's all Obama and these elitists need.
I know. As you say, you're right. I mean, you've been involved in the overthrow of countries. You've been involved in the stopping them. And I know you know what you're talking about. I see it happening. I just cannot believe they're actually trying a leftist communist playbook, destabilization, overthrow. But it appears, ladies and gentlemen, this is not a dry run. This is not a beta test. It appears they're really looking to go
We're
with
on the
this.
March.
Stay with
the
us.
Empire.
You know, I'm going to say this because I want people to supporting during the breaks. Larry has to go to the bathroom. He's really focusing and even be able to be on air with us right now. He's battling lung cancer. They don't want me to tell people that, but it's known. The government knows that. He knows they can slip in and take him out and, use the fact that he's so sick as the cover there in the home of Arkansas. But his information on Hillary and Bill is out there. It's in a lot of different places. It's going to start rolling out, as you've been seeing, through Trump and obviously the National Enquirer. And, I mean, this isn't a guy over here saying he's talking to the Trump people. We probably won't even get into this. Or when I have Colonel Smith Meck on, who's exposing what base is shipping arms on a train to Mexico to be sent to Al-Qaeda and ISIS. You understand, when they come on this show, they get physically attacked, you know, a few days after, or they get death threatened, or the Justice Department calls up and threatens Plumlee. We're not up here saying, hey, we're tough guys. We're up here saying, this country's being taken down in front of everybody. The public's in a trance. And if we expose their plans to use an economic collapse and race war to bring in martial law, as they've pretty much already done in Europe, they may have to back off. And then people say, oh, you're a fear monger. It didn't happen. Oh, like the NSA spying or the Internet ID. It's all going to happen if we don't stop them. You understand? It isn't like I'm sitting here going, boy, I hope all this happens so I'll be a superstar. Oh, wonderful. We ever get out from under the New World Order, they'll say, boy, that Alex Jones was like Paul Revere with Matt Drudge and, you know, people like Larry Nichols. Boy, isn't that great. How's that help Larry Nichols' kids or my kids or his grandkids? This is a full fight, people. He's up here in Hillary's face. She can't stand him. It's come out in lawsuits before and federal cases where the feds have got our emails and are watching what we're doing and stuff. I mean, believe me, this is not games. This isn't people acting like they're on the cutting edge. This isn't people acting like they're giving you the big breaking news. This is people risking everything for this republic. We're going to go back to Larry here in just a moment. It's just I see a guy over here fighting for his life and fighting for his country's life and gutting up to be on air, you know, with his surgery and all the rest of it. And I just think about the average men that are strong, that are smart, that are tough, that if their neighbor got in their face and slapped their wife, you know, this, you know, these men would stand up. But when the globalists conquer your country and rub your face in it and just dominate and overthrow our nation and attack God and the family and everything else and unborn babies, the average man just gets a glazed look in his eye. And I want to ask Larry Nichols, why is that? Maybe it's just they never thought of themselves as fighting tyranny, or they don't respect themselves, or it's like government's another world. It runs things. No, it doesn't. We're the people. And it is this pliant attitude where you bend over to the New World Order. Listen, the New World Order doesn't just want to have its way with you. It wants to slit your frickin' throat, people. It's coming to break you. It's got a destabilization program it's running that we've seen in other countries. We know where point A to Z goes. And let me tell you, we're already down to like X. And in the last few letters, there'll be more change than you saw in all the other progression. You'll just be, boom, and you're in a nightmare situation. Boom, there's no money in the bank. Boom, there's no food. Boom, there's black uniforms. Boom, the social justice warriors by the hordes pour out everywhere and start burning targeted select areas. And they call the police in and they say, we've made a deal with some of these other groups and the feds. You go out and get these political subversives that are stirring up the left and you won't be fired. If the police go out and arrest the patriots at that point, you'll be the next ones. Just know that. They are quarterbacking us. We got their playbook. I don't know which play they're going to play next, but I got a good idea off watching this coach, watching this team. We're going to our guest here in a moment, just briefly, to put up on the screen for TV viewers and radio listeners. He is battling for his life. He's lost everything in the last 20-plus years, battling the Clintons for being a very successful businessman. He needs help for medical care. He didn't even ask for this, but I insist on doing it. Nichols Live at AOL.com for a PayPal donation. He's tried to write books and do other stuff, and it always turns into fiasco, and you know how that works. People run, you know, he never gets the money or whatever. Point is, he needs your support. Nichols Live at AOL.com. Nichols Live at AOL.com. Or Larry Nichols, 58 Kensington Drive, Conway, Arkansas, 72034. That's 58 Kensington Drive, Conway, Arkansas, 72034. Nichols Live at AOL.com with PayPal. Now, before I go any further, I skipped a break this hour. I skipped one last. I got to stop doing it. It's like a habit you can't break. I don't even plug. When I do plug, you need to buy the products. We need your support. We're all in this together. Get the Hillary for President shirts. Get the Molon Labe shirts. We've got dozens and dozens of great shirts. Get the high-quality storable food. Get the colloidal silver natural disinfectant antibiotic. That when all else fails, it's a silver bullet, folks. And then we've also got the new air filter system that, by the folks that make the Alexa Pure water filters that are game changers, the Alexa Pure Breeze. I've bought units that are $900, $1,000 years ago. And the whole industry prices have gone down some. Now, something comparable that's pretty good is about $500. This is normally $220-something. It's $180. What is it, $184, $86? And put it back on screen. I'm going from memory. It's 25% off. Technically, it's 26% off, 26.02 off. On the Alexa Pure Breeze, groundbreaking ion cluster technology, but that's just part of the filters it has. It's got other filters. It's got no reviews yet. It's out of the gates. It's been tested and developed for years. It's almost completely silent. It is a game changer. I'm not going to sit here and beat a dead horse. You're crazy if you don't go get yourself one of these. If you don't filter your water, they got glyphosate and everything in the water, the fluoride. Alexa Pure Pro water filtration, Alexa Pure Breeze, air filtration systems. We also have the ProPure water systems that are excellent, LifeStraw and others. But InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com for the nutraceuticals, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And if you're feeding your kids GMO food, or, and I'm not on you about this, I know you're in a habit, you wonder why your kids seem dull, stop feeding them GMO, stop feeding them red dye number 5, stop giving them aspartame drinks. None of us are perfect. It's a long journey back from hell, isn't it? But we can get there. I mean, I never did that bad stuff. But the point is, you're giving them tap water, you're insane. Most well water, you name it, it's horrible. Hundreds of bad chemicals. You need to filter your water. You need to buy this product that supports the First Amendment, and then it helps you. It's a win-win. They have an Alexa Pure whole family of systems, and they have the ProPure systems. They're all available at InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. We have a 4-stage ProPure shower filter that's the best out there, and it's such an affordable price. There are competitors that have one filter of charcoal and cost $70. This is $60-something bucks. It's got 4 filters, and here's the great part. It's fast flow, so it doesn't screw up your shower. This is the way to do it. If you got a baby, fill the bathtub up with the shower head. You know, they're doing this on purpose, not to mention all the runoff. Don't let them hit you with chemical weapons. Purify your air. Take care of your body. Get exercise. Get sunshine. And most importantly, pray to God and get your soul right, because pointing that at God is the most important thing. When Larry Nichols says get right with Jesus, he means it, folks. I've gotten so much closer to God because I've studied this and I've seen evil and I know how real it is. And I'm telling you, folks, if you're not right with God and you don't have God on your side and you're not asking God for protection and discernment and you're not asking God to help you meet other people who are looking for other good folks as well, you're in for a lot of trouble, because I've never got up on air and talked about stuff being this scary. I'm always hoping we can push it back and change it and derail it. That's why I've gotten so much more hardcore and so much more risky with what I do. I mean, we've pulled out all the stops here going up against the enemy, just doing stuff that I know when I do it is sticking my head in a lion's mouth. So, and I'm not talking about a train one at the circus. So I'm doing what I got to do, because if I don't, I die inside. But I just want you to understand something. The fear you ought to have is not standing up to these people. We got to recognize them as evil and make a clean break with them and just absolutely get in their face politically at every level and say, you are anathema, you are evil, you stage things and blame it on us, you hate us, you want to bankrupt us, you want to mount our heads on your walls figuratively and for real, and we are setting our will, our guts, our spirit, everything and against it and saying, God, we're all in, and God then, like wind in the sails, will come in. I'm telling you, that's how this works. And it doesn't mean you won't be persecuted or go through some trouble. But the enemy hates us because they don't even like us being around, these psychopaths and sociopaths. They're scared of us, and they want to break our will. And we have got to take action. Now, Larry, I've been ranting. I want to give you the floor now. I apologize. I'm not going to take calls. I want to give you more time. It's just, this is such an epic time when just more stuff's happening in a week now than used to happen in a year. And it's accelerating, and I just now... I mean, I have a beyond a horrified feeling in my chest. It's just, I'm like, where's the person to fight? I'm like, ready. I know how sick these people are. And every fiber of me is like desperately trying to find the lever, the switch to throw to turn the tide. And we're turning the tide at many levels is why they're accelerating. So I want to get into Trump, what you're working on, and play some clips here. Larry, go ahead.
Well, what you're talking about, Alex, is Einstein did it. He did take a string with a ball on the end of it, say 10 foot long, spin that ball around. Now, I want you to take that same ball, cut that string in half, spin it around, and the ball goes faster. Now, you cut that string in half, and it's zipping. And the closer you get to your hand, that ball's moving fast, fast, fast. Now, you know, he called the point at which the energy is initiated to spin that ball. He called it the event. And as the ball gets closer to to the event. In other words, as time gets closer to the event, things speed up exponentially. We're seeing that right now, Alex. We're seeing it. That's why today things seem to be developing faster than we can even imagine. Then there's another trick they have, and they use this one almost every day. This is where Hillary is so significant. Most people, Alex, have in their mind the level to which they will do something sinister and evil. In other words, you, Alex, in your mind, if you sat down and said, okay, what is the worst thing I could do? I mean, being mean, evil, sinister, how far would I go? And you've got a limit. The Clintons use that. I used to use it on people. People have innately in them a limit to how far they will go to be evil and to get what they want. The Clintons have no limit. And so we're sitting here, you and I, Alex, we're trying to convince people you can't believe what these people will do because people don't believe anybody would do it.
That's what I'm saying. Most people have got to get aggressive, focused, yes, and confident and really start thinking about your limits, because here's the deal. They're going to push us, folks, if we don't start pushing back all the way to the limit where things get really nasty. And that's what I'm saying, Larry. I've looked at the tea leaves here, all the different evidences. I think they've miscalculated, and when they push us to the limit, I think they're going to cause a chain of events that is going to bring them down. I mean, what's your view?
I know you're right, Alex. I know you're right. What we have to get your listeners, our people, over is everybody said, you know, you were saying a minute ago, what about the average male? You know, why won't he engage? What is it about him? If somebody slaps his wife around, of course he'll engage. But when it comes to this, to the nation, to the country, to the future, you know, there's a big sense out there of what can I do? One man. How can I change things? Well, folks, we're going to snap out of that. And we either snap out of that fast or it's over for us. Now, it does not, Alex, take every man, woman, and child in America to wake up and to resist these people. The truth is, Alex, it takes less people to resist them than you think. It's just we've got to have people that are willing to engage and get in the fight.
You said willing, and willing is a breakdown of will.
That's right. And when I say engage in the fight, Alex, everybody doesn't have to do like you. They don't have to start a company, risk their life, get on the air, and invest everything they have every day, risk every dime they have to be able to get the word out and to tell the truth. They don't have to do that. Everybody has a place. Everybody has a role. You know, everybody's not a car mechanic. Everybody's not a brain surgeon. We don't need everybody to be monolithic. What we need is everybody bring to the party that which you do. That's what our founding fathers did. They said butchers, bakers, candlestick makers, preachers, let's all come and let's get in this thing. And many did. But remember, folks, please remember this. The Revolutionary War was not fought by every person that was in this country.
3%.
Less than 4%, right, less than 4% of the people in this country at that time actually participated, and we won. We can win today if we can get 4% of our population to engage. Now, here's where it gets kinky. We need everybody to unify under one, let's say, umbrella. I guess that's what you call an umbrella.
Now, but where is that George Washington? And that's the problem. And they're worried about states coalescing and forming that. That's why the entire Pentagon plan is to take out a states movement when they bring us under open globalism. But the public has to be prepared in the information warfare realm, in the battle space, to recognize that global attempt to destroy the states is illegitimate. And then just with political will, none of us comply. Doesn't matter how many troops they put in the streets. Plus, the most awake group is the special forces community. I mean, I'm sure you know that.
I know, but let me tell you, you asked the question, where is the George Washington? I never believed Bill Clinton on much he ever said, but there was one thing I heard him say one time when he was president that was actually true. You know, great moments and events create great men. It might be Donald Trump, Alex. I'll tell you something else. It might be you. It might be. I don't know. We won't know until we engage. One of the things
resistance is victory. This is so key what you're saying. This is the absolute key to everything. We don't know till we engage. We engage, right. We win. We have the moral high ground in history. We lay down, they win. We cannot lose if we engage. It doesn't mean we're all going to make it either, folks.
That's right. You know, what happened when the Allied forces crossed the Rhine into the Germany? Hey, it got tough. You know why? Because the Germans at that point were fighting for their homeland. Folks, we're fighting for our homeland. Don't be convinced any other way. We are fighting for our country. Engage. Engage. And everything will show itself when we do.
That's right. We have to smoke the enemy out by every person everywhere engaging. We'll talk about some ways to engage when we come back. But the key is just have the will to do it and the doors will open. Just ask God to. I haven't gotten any of the Donald Trump clips. And boy, they're powerful. Obama stumbling around, bumbling around, trying to tag him back. Kids being brainwashed, white kids, black kids, Hispanic kids, just kids to say horrible things about Trump, that he's racist. He said he hates Jews. I'm Jewish. I mean, he didn't say he hates Jews or black people or Hispanics or anybody. But again, it just shows. And these parents are in the background of these clips. They're up on Infowars.com going, good. They sound like snakes. I just thank God I had parents that were involved and informed and studied history. And my mom's got a degree in history. And it's true. People that don't know history are doomed to repeat it. Larry Nichols was getting into the fact that they're getting us to a point of our backs being against the wall. They've made it racial. And I love the fact that despite the fact they said the Tea Party was racist, that some Hispanics and black folks would come to it. But now I'm seeing a lot of these rallies where half the folks are Hispanic. It's incredible. And huge numbers of black folks who really see through it. And I mean, are there going to be some racist people at Trump rallies? Absolutely. But I mean, I'm a white guy. Believe me, most white people I know are the opposite of racist. They're self-loathing. Okay. I mean, most people don't like themselves in this modern society. You give them another reason, they're going to be into it. There's a lot of self-hating going on, no matter what color you are. We're just people. And he has such a unifying message, but of sovereignty. We need that. They're killing that. Hey, we got open borders. Hey, they're bringing in radicals. Hey, sure, he's giving people red meat because that's the first thing people get. Hey, my life's falling apart, but I got to pay for all this. So I was talking to Larry Nichols. I want to keep him in the next hour a little bit if he can do it. He's probably got to go. About solutions. How do people get involved at first? How do people take action at first? What do they do? And there's 1,000 ways to do it. The biggest way in the information war is the internet, to take our articles, our videos, our material, stories, this Larry Nichols video that's live right now, and send it to people. That's number one. But number two, run for office locally. Number three, start a shooting club, whatever. It's all little things in the culture that will break the globalists back. Call and talk radio. Do your own YouTube channel. I want to keep you a little bit if you got to go, at least on the Trump stuff and what's about to roll out. I don't know how much that was inside baseball or outside baseball because you were telling Nico and he related, but a lot of exciting stuff there. And, of course, you want to communicate directly to the Trump folks. We're saying through this platform, not with them for reasons that are obvious. But spend a few minutes with us here on solutions. How does somebody who's never really been involved, how do they get involved?
All right. First off, Alex, I'm glad you asked me. Now, guys, there's a couple of things I want to make very, very clear. You know, Alex, bless his heart, ask you to help me. I need it. I'm not going to say I don't. I'm not going to say what on earth. I'm not saying I don't, but I cannot. My thingies. Do you hear that, Alex?
No, your computer's going crazy. It's okay, but it's not coming across here.
Well, anyway, what I want you to know is you don't have to do. You don't have to send me money, but here's what you better do. You had better get on Alex's email list. You've got to. I'm sorry, y'all. I don't know where that's coming from. You better get on Alex's email list.
Absolutely, because with all the internet censorship intensifying, with all the internet, that's how we were able to communicate with folks. And yes, it's for marketing to fund ourselves as well, but it is more important than ever. I've never really even used it for marketing until now to reach people with the censorship increasing. Now, Larry, do you have another show coming up? Do you have to go?
Well, I do, but I'll look, this is too important. I can't stop at this point. Listen.
Okay, well, I got to go to break in 1 minute. I want to come back and give you the floor for just five more on the Trump situation. There's been new Trump developments.
Absolutely. But one thing quickly, get on the email list. And then, folks, I'm telling you, every one of you, this comes from me. I get nothing out of it. It don't mean nothing to me. It means a lot to me to protect you because you're the Army. You have got to stock up for a month or two or three or six. Have food stuff. Be prepared. Be prepared if they shut down the system.
That's how they want to control us. That's why they want us so dependent. Larry Nichols is with us until 15 minutes into this hour. Then he's got another interview he's doing. This guy is battling cancer. If you're radio listener, you can't see him there with the bandages on his throat from surgery, and they've got it opened up so they can put a trachea when they need to, and he's on oxygen, and the guy's tough. And, you know, in the fictional world of Breaking Bad, the guy cooks methamphetamine to try to fund, you know, his cancer treatment with Larry Nichols. He just puts up a PayPal for folks to support him. We're going to put that up before he leaves us again. And then Joe Begg's going to join us from the Social Justice Warriors on the Road. I'm going to open the phones up. And we also have David Knight honchoing the fourth hour. Larry, I want to hit the Trump stuff when we come back in the next segment because this one's short. But finishing up with solutions, if people just spread the word about this broadcast or other broadcasts that are telling the truth, if people educate Congress, I mean, there are a lot of good people. We have to normalize reality. We know reality's scary. We know it's sensational. We know it's scary to have to talk about it, but it is happening. And so we need to force this out in the open. But then what do we do after that point when they've got most of the key positions filled with other criminals? And we know the government's criminal. 6% of the public trust the media in an AP poll, scientific. What happens at that point where most of the military is awake? A lot of the FBI is awake. They're not all bad people. Secret Service, I know, is awake. But the people on top are these horrible clowns like Hillary. What do we do about this stalemate or impasse?
All right, first thing you got to do, Alex, is what you did and what you and I did back when Bill Clinton. We have to set up an overall umbrella, all right? Now, a lot of people are awake, but the problem we have, Alex, is a lot of people have their pet peeve issues. Some people are against this. Some people are against this. We've got to unify under the one thing, save this country. Forget all of the smaller issues, get unified under one issue, the big picture. We got to save the country. Now, once we do that, once we come together, we've got to identify ourselves, Alex. That's the problem. We must identify ourselves. That's why I beg people to get on your email list. We've got to know how many people and who we've got in our army. Now, with that, then we can attack, and I mean attack, the people that are in Washington, the good ones. Yes, we've got to give them the faith that there are enough people behind us to back them, that they're not out there on the limb by themselves. And then we've got to be able to cut through the media and attack the Clintons. And how do you do that? That's where Donald Trump comes in. Donald Trump is our great hope. You see, Trump, if he will keep doing what he's doing, he gives us access, Alex, to the people going around the media. You know, he talks straight to the people. The media tries to block him at every turn. He don't care. He just tweets or twigs or whatever he does. He gets the word out. That's where we gather.
Unified. And that's what he's been able to do is a focal point. And the fact that he's going with your research, Drudge's research, our research, and really putting in the Clintons' face is absolutely terrifying them.
Imagine this. What happened, Alex, let's just imagine Trump getting up in a speech and he says, you know, they have said that the whole Vince Foster thing is solved. There's nothing to it. It's all put to bed. What if in that speech he was given, he held up the Secret Service memo and he read it and he said, now, does this sound like it was solved? Him doing that would set the media on fire. The whole world would know.
The whole thing will come back out again. And just like the Saudi 28 pages, that's all out now or starting to come out because of that. Absolutely.
So there are moves. We have to remember, Alex, in any battle, any military person you know will tell you there is strategic and tactical. We must understand strategically what our goal is. Our goal, folks, is nothing but save our country.
And then tactically, how do we do it?
Tactically, it's how we do it. Number one, we stop Hillary. Number two, we move to the only true thing that saves this nation, and that is moving back to...
I'm kind of torn with some of those new liners that we've done, because it sounds like we're... And now, in Las Vegas, Nevada, the big fight night. But then the other side of it is, no, we're this is an epic battle. We need to have, like, horns going off and sirens and air raid sirens. I mean, it is crazy that InfoWars is one of the most prominent organizations still promoting Americana, basic free market, due process, live in a free country. And that we're just overrun with globalist propaganda and dumbing down. It is an amazing time to be alive. Larry Nichols leaves us here in a few minutes. Joe Biggs is coming on. I will get to all these Trump clips. I was trying to get a bunch of them this morning. They had them ready for showtime. And then I'm like, hurry up and get me that. And then I don't play it for 2 hours. So they need to slap me around sometimes. But it's epic what's going on. And remember, America isn't the whole planet. Every form of insanity is intensifying in other areas because the globalists admittedly have been creating economic conditions that exacerbate that on record. So I want Larry Nichols here to impart to the audience, again, top Clinton insider, formerly basically handling the Clintons to a great extent when he was governor. And then it just got so corrupt, he had to start fighting back. He was the main guy in the Clinton Chronicles and big news articles about it. One of the top people that was instrumental in getting information out through Drudge and David Shippers and others that finally got the impeachment of Clinton going. And even if it didn't finally convict him in the Senate, it punished him publicly and at least created the idea that you're not completely above the law. We're now in a climate, I'd say, 3-4 times worse, where just the lawlessness, not just the email gate or the, you know, Benghazi or Fast and Furious or all this, it's just incredible that we've reached this point. So in the last few minutes we have with Larry Nichols, you talked to Nika before the show today. I'd like to talk to you after the show. If we can, about how much of the Nichols Trump information we're allowed to talk about on air, or where this is all going. I mean, I know you've wanted to reach out to Trump. You've said that on the videos. And I know that those folks have reached out to you. I don't know how far you want to go on that. But obviously you were saying that you just want to impart the basic knowledge here publicly. And then, you know, hopefully Trump will then go the next step on Vince Foster, the next step on the rape. So, try to reveal to the audience here who's on pins and needles about this how much you can tell us, Larry Nichols.
Well, here's what I intend to do. And this will be up to Mr. Trump and what he does. Number one, if Donald Trump called me today, Alex, I would say to him, I would say, Mr. Trump, I support you, but I will not be an official part of your campaign in any way, because if we got caught being together, they would roast you horribly, because remember, they call me every kind of thing there is, they call him everything there is, and they would use both of us to discredit it. So therefore, what I would say to Mr. Trump is, I will go about every other week on Alex Jones, sure will, come right here if you would allow me, and I will release a new scandal, a new piece of the puzzle. Now, once I do that, it would be very wise for Mr. Trump to pick it up like he did the Vince Foster thing, pick it up and talk about it. You see, if he won't talk about it, what we break here, it will draw people, Alex, here to hear more of the story.
Sure. 2 months ago, you said Trump needs to go with Vince Foster. He did. So it's very exciting.
Well, and remember the strategy for Vince Foster, Alex, as you and I have talked about since day one. We're not going to get Hillary indicted over Vince Foster. We're not. But I tell you what we're going to do. I tell you what I'm going to do. And I hope you are in, and I know you are. We're going to make piece by piece by piece the true story about Vince Foster, the greatest whodunit in American history. People will get involved if they're entertained, Alex. If we try to tell them stuff and cram it down their throat in political terms and historical terms and all of that, they're not going to listen. But I tell you what, if we can entertain them, they'll buy into it. They'll learn. And you have to do it through repetition. So that's what I would say. I would say, Mr. Trump, just do me a favor. When I break something with Alex Jones, one thing that Alex makes me do, anything I break, I have to be able to prove in a court of law, which I will be able to do. So therefore, he will be safe with the subject matter and just let the people know it's out there. Now, if he does that, more people, Alex, outside of the moral Christian conservative community will come here. They'll come here to hear. And of course, when they come here, Alex, you know, I'm a one-trick pony. I'm Clinton. That's what I do. That's who I am. I will stop Hillary. I've made that pledge to the American people, and you just heard I made it to her. I'm Clinton. But there's an awful lot of other stuff that needs to be put out to people. So if we can draw them here using this campaign, they're not going to get it in the media, but they can get it here. They're going to learn.
Sure. And the tactic the media uses that I talked a lot about the first hour is they tell us what winners should do. They tell us what losing strategies are. And really, the strategies they give us are losing. They call them winning. So they say, oh, Trump's discredited. He talks about rape. Trump's discredited. He talks about murders from the 90s. And the media is so scared. And then he goes up 2-3 points in every major poll. He needs to go even further. And he's starting to do that. And he's decided, from what I've been seeing, to really take the gloves off. Roger Stone, if you can get through all the bad weather, is going to be here today in studio with us tomorrow. And we're going to do some special reports over the weekend. But I tell you, they're scared of Donald Trump. And it's because they've had a dossier on him forever. They got his phones tapped. He's not perfect. They just know he's pro-America. He's not a crook. He's not a child molester like most of them. And so they hate his guts. He's never been part of their club. He's been his own guy. To a point of, you know, he runs his own show completely. And so they just can't stand it because he's not a combine guy. He's not a syndicate guy.
Then the thing that I've got to count on you to do, Alex, you're going to have to help me convince Donald Trump that the true solution to solving America's woes is states' rights.
He needs to come out and talk about states' rights.
You bet. Strip that damn Washington.
That's what made America great was the checks and balances.
Exactly.
States' rights made America great.
You do that. If Trump will make a part of his platform, I'm talking about his legitimate platform, states' rights. Don't worry about what they'll try to do to him on foreign affairs. Guys, we got no business in foreign affairs until we clean up this country. We can't solve our problems.
His foreign affairs make a lot of sense. Don't start a war with Russia. Don't back ISIS and Al-Qaeda.
Yeah, just like his foreign affairs sounds good to me. Just don't get involved. So, Alex, you know, we've got work to do. I tell you another thing, it's probably about time. And I mean this, if you would do it, you're welcome to do it. Come in here. I think it's about time we need to do another one of those videos that you do. Put up a video. Let's talk
absolutely
about, like, well, you say, the solution.
Absolutely. In closing, Larry, I know you don't ask for this, but it's true you're battling cancer. We want to keep you around as long as possible, regardless if we weren't in this death battle. You got a lot of courage. I am very, very, very excited to try to take on the Clintons head-to-head. That's what I was born to stand up against these people just like you were. And so I feel honored before God and country to not be a coward and to stand with men like yourself and Donald Trump and Matt Drudge and so many others. And, of course, don't forget Judicial Watch and don't ever forget the folks who are doing it longer than anybody except you. And that'd be the Joseph Farah over at WorldNet Daily. They even predate Drudge and myself. So we all need to, you know, fight together. And the audience who all those years, little old ladies handing out copies of the Clinton Chronicles and myself putting it on Access TV in 1995. You know, that's the type of stuff we're talking about here. Larry Nichols, we're going to put on screen your PayPal, NicholsLive@AOL.com, to help him battle cancer. Now, I know you don't want to talk about this. You told me some stuff privately, and I know you've, you know, been pretty close here a few times, but how are you doing?
I'll be all right. I'll be all right. I'll make it until, just folks, don't worry. I'll be here to stop Hillary. I'll be here to stop Hillary.
So are you almost feeding on this fight? Is it giving you strength to hang on?
That's it. You know, let me tell you, the one thing that you have to have, Alex, is I've learned a will to live. And that's in combat and anywhere. I've seen guys shot up, you'd say they're going to die, and they live. I've seen guys that look like, well, that wound didn't even hurt them, and they die. And what happens usually is their will to live. I've got a great purpose. It's a purpose bigger than myself, and that's trying to save this country, its selfish purpose, for my grandbabies. Now listen, another thing, Alex, that you said a while back is exactly true. Discernment. Folks, you've got to start being responsible, and you've got to learn to discern the truth. A true patriot seeks out the truth and then tells it, then passes it on. Be careful. Be careful just everything that pops up on that damn internet.
They feed out disinfo to clog everything so that when we're saying something true, or they misrepresent what I say. I mean,
exactly.
They're really deceptive.
And you got to watch out with the Clintons because they're masters at putting people out there that look like they're on your side, and they'll feed a tidbit or two of truth, and then people
exactly.
Know,
I mean, look, it's
gee,
just
that
like
person's right.
It's just like in warfare radar jamming. They just jam things with smoke and watch infighting. Anybody that ever infights and attacks other host for no reason is an operative. Glenn Beck always did that, so I took the high road and didn't until he's now basically falling. And I don't take any pleasure in that. It's very sad.
Right.
Because I'm not in competition with any of these guys. I'm trying to save this country. I mean,
let me tell you about Glenn Beck. Glenn Beck had his opportunity, and I give him credit for that 9/12. He helped establish the Tea Party to a great extent. But Glenn Beck made one mistake. He did not give people something to do. He told the problems. He told the problems. He did the history of the problems. Great. He got them. He got the horses to the trough, but he would not show them how to drink.
That's right, Brother Larry.
Got to.
We're praying for it. We'll be back with Joe Biggs, breaking news, and a bunch of Trump clips.
And your breath.
You heard Larry Nichols talk about how important, with all the internet censorship kicking off, that we have emails to communicate with each other. I've never been a big email guy. I don't really use a lot of email. And I've never really tried to sit there, even in the golden age of email 20 years ago, and tried to get folks to come sign up for free newsletters and all the rest of this. But we do send out key articles and videos every day. And we do have little promo specials and things where you save a lot of money at InfoWarsStore.com when you sign up there. So if you buy our products, you should be signed up. But we don't spam you with ads. We mainly send you material. I'm more interested in getting the material out than the marketing. The marketing is the powder that funds the operation that projects the bullet down the barrel. That's where we're wanting to go. But for a whole group of reasons, we do need to have an email to be in contact with InfoWarriors. So InfoWars.com/newsletter. Also, I just want to encourage everybody, this is a war. And I know you're doing a lot. I want to thank you for what you're doing. But the most important thing you can do temporarily on this planet, praying to God's most important, and getting right with God, is send our articles, our videos, our information that you think is the most informative, that you judge to be the most pertinent, out to everyone you know constantly. Facebook, Twitter, all the globalist platforms. We're in a war. Post my videos to your own YouTube channel or, to your Facebook channel, whatever. It's I don't have enough crew to put our videos on every platform I wish we could. I'm trying to hire people so I can do that just to get the word out. And I'm not complaining. I didn't even have a crew to send Michael Zimmerman out to the West Coast with Biggs. Now he's there. I think he's getting him at the airport right now. Dude's got to go on vacation sometime with his family for a couple days before he goes to cover Bilderberg. I don't have the crew, and I'm not complaining. I just want to do more. And so help us get the word out. Buy our products. Spread the word. But also do things like proliferate the articles, the videos across the internet, and just keep hammering it. And I know you're doing that. And if you're listening to a local AM or FM station or watching us, say, in Houston on cable TV, where we're on there daily and nightly, we're on like 24 hours a day, basically, support that affiliate, but also spread the word about that oasis of information. And hey, maybe my style's not good for you. Fine, we got all these other great reporters, all these great guests, all this research, all these special reports. I mean, we are a arsenal in defense of liberty. Now, he'll be with us about 10 minutes in the next segment, and then I'm going to go to more of these clips I haven't gotten to and try to take some calls at 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. But we are at an epic point right now in civilization. When you watch what the globalists and the think tanks and the big foundations and the CIA have created at universities That's not some leftist aberrant thing. That's what the elite wanted for America. Dumb, hateful, anti-free speech, nasty people. And Joe Biggs has been in the middle of it now a few days, and the reinforcements are there. Zimmerman flew out there this morning. So great job, Joe Biggs. For a few minutes, tell us what you've witnessed and what's coming up tonight.
Well, what we do is we have an update in the UCLA shooting. This guy apparently had a kill list. And ding, 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 same as last time in San Bernardino, they all came out and said the shooter was white. Comes to find out, in fact, he wasn't. And now they can't play the race card anymore, and you're not hearing as much about it.
Oh, too bad. So the guy wasn't white, so they can't talk about it anymore. Too bad.
Yeah, his name's Manak Sarkar. He drove from Minnesota. He's linked to a murder of a woman in Minnesota, and they found a kill list at his home in Minnesota. And on that name was another professor that didn't get killed, luckily, at UCLA. So the one guy got killed, and then he turned the gun on himself and shot himself. But he had a
wow. I wonder why that was out of the news, guys. Absolutely. Yeah, sure. So it's not in the news now. We'll pull that article up in the next segment. Isn't that interesting, Joe?
Yeah, I mean, it's always interesting that way. They always want to, you know, blame it on a white guy. And then once that white privilege isn't to blame for whatever's happening, then they kind of just go quiet and hush it.
Now, you're following the social justice warriors as they shut free speech down around the state. What's coming up tonight?
Tonight, Milo will be speaking at the UC Irvine campus at 7 p.m. I don't have the exact building location yet. They haven't given that to me. I usually get it a couple hours ahead of time. But that will be at 7 p.m. tonight, so I want to encourage everyone to come out. That is close to Costa Mesa. It's like right there, and we're expecting that to be a very intense night tonight. So I want to see everybody out there.
Sure, for those that don't know, this is a Breitbart tech editor. And everywhere he goes, they just attack him. Anybody that doesn't support Mao Zedong gets attacked. I mean, I'm serious. Google now supports Mao. David Knight is going to be a fresh horse in the fourth hour coming into the fight. He'll be covering Waterfront. Obviously, there's so much breaking. Let's put on screen, since Joe Biggs mentioned this. This broke about 2 hours ago, 3 hours ago. And he appears to be a gentleman of Indian descent. That did the shooting yesterday and then committed suicide there. So that's one person he killed and himself. We can back that out. I can give folks the headline. UCLA shooting gunman, Mr. Sarka, had killed, as police chiefs say. And there's no mention, was he a Christian? Was he a Hindu? Was he a Muslim? There's a mix of that in India, obviously. But it doesn't matter. Why is it always only important if they're white to then make a big deal out of it? Now, you see, if someone's a Muslim and does it because they say it's part of a jihad, then that's a terror attack. Or if the feds stage a terror attack, or a criminal cell inside the feds stage a terror attack and blame it on the Patriot movement, you know, then they say it's a white domestic terrorism because it's a white guy, even though McVeigh said he didn't do it for white nationalist reasons. And the Southern Poverty Law Center was running the Elohim City compound of white supremacists. So that's what's really going on there. But to me, the big news is EU proposes government ID to use internet. And the way the EU bureaucracy works, I have it right here. This is given to the European Economic and Social Committee and the Committee on the Regions. And then those committees decide. Parliament is ceremonial, but it says Parliament. Communication from the Commission to the European Parliament, the Council, the European Economic and Social Committee, and the Committee of the Regions. And you read it, man, it is taxing the web, tracking you, deciding what websites can be up, going after hate speech. And inside the EU, they're arresting people from Sweden to Germany who mildly criticize. In Germany, this Iraqi been arrested twice. Robbing stores, walking around in a pajama outfit, obviously mentally ill. It was the third time the police wouldn't come. So guys come in and restrain him, take him to the cops, and they're saying they're now going to, they're looking at indicting them. That story is up on Infowars.com. The, quote, vigilantes, because it's so lawless. In some towns, they'll have like 100 people in the town. They bring 700-plus, quote, migrants. And grandmothers call their grandsons to protect them, and the police arrest them. They're like, no. I mean, and then they have the Arabs on TV that speak German going, the whites need to die. And the Germans go, yes. I mean, this is how sick the liberals are, folks. And the Muslims are just looking around going, really, really? You're scum? I hate you? You like that? Yes, good job. You hate me. I mean, and now the Germans that aren't completely mentally ill are being arrested. So this all ties together where Joe Biggs goes to these events. Any conservative speaks anywhere. In fact, I ought to pull these stunts just to show how First Amendment's under attack. I get invited to universities all the time and just say no because I'm too busy. You know, I can only reach a few thousand people there instead of reaching millions every day on the air. It's not that I'm arrogant and don't want to go, but wait a minute. I can go to these two. That's smart. That's what Breitbart, before he died, originally would do, was show how crazy and hateful they were. But now they just say openly, we're going to shut you down. We're going to shut you up. So this all dovetails together, Joe. I don't know if you've seen the site today. You've been busy. I know you're traveling right now to pick up Zimmerman, your cameraman. But this is pretty incredible with this EU commission. What do you think?
Yeah, I haven't had a chance to see all of that yet. But talk about what you were just mentioning a second ago about these social justice warriors. The interesting thing is whenever I go to these events, I always ask them, you know, why don't you like Trump or why don't you like, you know, Milo or whoever, you know? And they go, well, Trump's a racist. He wants to build a wall. Meanwhile, they're telling me this as they're linked together in a human chain, creating a wall, stopping people from going in to a free speech event. I just find it hilarious that they think walls are racist, but they create a wall to keep people out from an event where they can actually learn something.
Now, Joe, obviously your viral videos are on Infowars.com. They're on the YouTube page. We premiere a lot of them on the nightly news this evening. You've been to a couple of these now. It seems like they're progressively getting more insane. You were also telling us how the police have been somewhat, in some cases, supportive of these people trying to violate the free speech.
Yeah, they were really, really relaxed when it came to the protesters and more aggressive this time towards us, you know, at UCLA. You know, whenever we would say, hey, can you get some of these people out of here? Not me, but the, you know, the people that were running the event, say, hey, can you get some of these guys out of here? They're disrupting everything. They were like, no. But then they would allow those protesters to, like, bump into people and then claim to be assaulted. I mean, it was just completely and totally ridiculous. But, I mean, that's California. I mean, for example, last night I went out and I ran into a guy that made that, you know, you saw that shirt that says Hitlery on it?
Yes.
And I said, hey, can you do have one on you? I don't have a shirt. And he goes, yeah, let's go to my truck. So there was three of us, and one guy had a shirt on that had a picture of Obama and it said a-hole. Another one had a picture of Hillary that said Hitlery. And another one had a picture of Hillary that has a word that rhymes with bunt. And I said, let's go into this place and see if we can trigger some people. Hour goes by, no one says anything. And then this big fat guy comes up to me and he goes, can I get a picture with you? And I go, yeah. And then he walks off and he goes, you effing asshole, screw you. Hillary's a goddess, blah, 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 blah. And I was like, oh, here we go. And the owner kicked us out of the bar because our shirts were hate speech. And they could not have hate speech.
Okay. I've been able to follow the news breaking in InfoWars so fast while I've been on air today. I've been trying to track it. Do we have footage of this? This is golden.
No, I didn't. My phone had just died. This was like later on in the evening. And that's when the idea popped in my head to go do this. So I'm going to try it again tonight when we go out. We're going to wear the same shirt. And then I'm going to have Zimmerman with us as well to be able to film it.
Good. Well, Let's recreate this show. So people with anti-Hillary shirts not allowed and given service. I mean, that's what this is about. It's where this is headed. But I'm sure that if you're wearing a gay shirt, it'd be all right. And, of course, you know, or you just go set them up and, you know, put fag on the cake. And that's what they do. But I'm not saying you should do that.
I've never been so just, like, shocked in my entire life. Like, the music stopped. Like, there was an Irish band that was at an Irish pub. The music stopped as this bouncer and the owner of this Irish pub comes up to me and he goes, screw your free speech. You can't say, he's like, you can't have a shirt like this. It's offensive. It's hate speech. Get your hate speech out of here. And I'm sitting there like, dude, you're out of your effing mind.
Man, I wish you had that on. Please go back. Wow. We need more of that.
I'm going back to the exact same spot tonight. And I'm going to see if that happens again. The same three people wearing the same shirt, doing it all over again.
Good. Well, great job, Joe. Get Zimmerman. Get back on the road. How many more days are you going to be there? A couple more?
Right now, this is the last event for Milo, but we're scheduled to leave tomorrow. But if anything pops up, I mean...
Student groups, tweet at Alex Jones on Twitter or at Rambo Biggs on Twitter. If you want your student group to host Joe Biggs, we've already gone and done this in Portland because they tried to ban six Trump supporters from being able to have an event. So we show up the next weekend. Let's have Joe Biggs go out and do a tour with a few other folks and the Hitlery shirt. I mean, this is a lady that said, you know, she went to Libya, came and saw, and she killed. She's a warmonger. I think we can, you know, she said blacks are predators and need to be made to heal. So I think we can call her Hitlery. But regardless whether the speech is true or not, you have a right. And I think we should have a Hillary for prison event. I mean, that's it. We should have a Hillary for prison college tour. And you can wear the Hillary for prison. The Hitlery guy can wear his shirt. And we can sit there and really show folks what's going on, because that's how we illustrate what these folks are up to. We should have a rally on the sidewalk outside this guy's bar who wants to get rid of our free speech. Joe Biggs, we'll be following what you do, my friend.
Roger that. Thank you, sir, for having me on.
Thank you. Wow. I tell you. Okay. I have all these clips, and I've only played a couple of them today, so let's start with the clips. I mentioned this in the first hour. What Donald Trump is doing, not just saying, oh, crooked Hillary and laughing, but saying, these people are crooked. They're putting out disinfo on me. She works for crooks. These are criminals. This will bring them down, ladies and gentlemen, because they are criminals. And if he takes the gloves off, it's over. And Trump knows they're going to come after him regardless with made-up stuff. His only chance he's got is to hit him with everything he's got and to not hold back. In fact, if I have any problem with Trump, is he's not going far enough. Let's play this clip of him talking about how they're crooks this morning. Here it is.
Listen to this one. Hillary Clinton, when she was Secretary of State, ran up $1 trillion in trade deficits with China. $1 trillion. Great job, Hillary. Hillary, a great job, Hillary. You're doing a great job. Crooked Hillary, crooked, crooked Hillary. She's a crooked person. See, I'm being nice. At the same time, Secretary Clinton was surrendering our jobs to China. The Chinese government and its supporters were funneling huge sums, I mean huge sums of money to Bill Clinton so that he gives speeches. So she's giving China all these deals, and China's paying him vast amounts of money to make speeches. Great job. Great job. I'm sure they never discussed it. I'm sure it had nothing. I'm sure it was just a coincidence. Folks, when are you going to get? These are crooked people. These are crooked people. They've been crooked from the beginning. They were crooked with Whitewater. They've been crooked from the beginning. You look at that foundation. It's pure theft and pure crookedness. Read the book. The book is unbelievable. In fact, now they just came out with a movie. It's coming out like very soon. But read the book. These are crooked people. We don't need another 4 years of Clinton. Believe me, we don't need it.
That, folks, is powerful. And it went on and on and on. And I needed to watch that because I kind of got upset in the first hour. And it's been a powerful show, but I should be more optimistic, because when you attack these criminals and really hit them head on, they melt like a witch having a big bucket of water thrown on them. I'm melting. Oh, what a world. I mean, it's a joke that this leering jack-o'-lantern-faced Joker woman with a big rubber head with all the dead people behind her just running around with a bunch of dumbed-down people they're going to vote for because she's a woman. I mean, the gimmicks are just incredible. And there's Donald Trump, ready to take the gloves off even more. He is going to tear them to pieces. I got an even bigger clip coming up in the next segment. In fact, there's so many of these clips. I'm sure David will do a better job than I did in the fourth hour. Make sure, I know he's watching. Please, David, it's like 15, 20 clips here. I mean, this is amazing. In fact, Nico Acosta, you do such a great job along with everybody else. You've got to make me get to these clips. I know you try to get me to. It's just that this is amazing. Most of these clips are on InfoWars.com. I mean, look at this one. Obama blames right-wing radio for making people think big government is the problem. And he talks about how government's giving us jobs, and that, no, government takes people's money and redistributes it. And it picks winners and losers. And we want a limited government. And then we've got this one. I'm going to play this one. Obama tries to trash Donald Trump and turns into a stuttering mess. And I just love the piece David Knight did. Maybe he'll air that in the fourth hour, the piece he did for radio. You know, for the radio feed, we like get rid of commercials and just put information in them most of the time. We're trying to make the ads Interesting, again, people don't even listen to ads, as everybody knows. Well, we're actually bringing folks back to the ads because we're inserting vignettes of truth in there and information warfare. But this is Obama at a commencement speech. I mean, Drudge had the headline up there with just the video as the top story of him bumbling around like a complete moron. Here it is.
Just because, it sounds funny, or the tweets are provocative, then we're not going to build on the progress that we started.
Yeah, that's not even the gold one, guys. That's not the one. That's not the clip I saw on Drudge, or it's only a piece of it. Do you guys have the one? Yeah, we'll play the full one. Here it is.
Turn against each other based on divisions of race or religion. If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okie doke, just because it sounds funny, or
they're scared,
tweets are provocative,
they're deer in the headlights right now,
then we're not going to build on the progress that we started.
Oh, the progress you've started. And then there's an even longer one online of him just because they don't know what to do. They've thrown all their lies out there, all their exaggerations, all the twisting, and it's not working. And people know that these folks are crooks. All they've got is maybe 30% of the population that is helpless and doesn't know how to get a job and doesn't know how to wipe their own noses and can't find their rear end with both hands. A bunch of sniveling social justice warriors. And he talks about Trump spewing race. Trump's countering this orgy of anti-American, anti-white, anti-Christian, anti-just prosperity craziness. Total divide and conquer. There's a really powerful supercut here of a Donald Trump top 7 reasons why Hillary Clinton should never be elected. But let me tell you, he's starting to go there, and I've been saying it for weeks. Trump, go after them on the Loral and Hughes deal when Hillary signed off with Bill to allow the missile secrets from top to bottom to get a rocket off the ground, to get it into orbit, to get it back into orbit, and to have the nose cone come off. And you got 12 to 24 individual rockets with hydrogen bombs on the end of them targeting certain cities. So say one comes in for Texas, nose cone pops off, it's got 24 missiles, only half of them actually have warheads, the others are decoys. And then they all sector in on their pre-targeted position and fire. That's what they did to us. And if Trump goes there, it's over. They're doing a good job. They're saying, plug, Alex, plug, absolutely. Look, we got the best products out there. We've gone out and scoured to find you the very best products, whether it's non-GMO seeds or nutraceutical, vitamins and supplements, or shortwave radios that are solar-powered, or solar-powered systems that are so amazing that we have at InfoWarsStore.com. We now have 25% off introductory offer of the revolutionary Alexa Pure Breeze air filter system that is just over-the-top amazing and is half the price of the leading competitors and just as good in side-by-side studies. And that's because prices are going down on these, thank God. Something like this used to be like $800, $900, $1,000. I paid $1,000 a couple years ago for systems that are as good as this. It is $184 right now, 25, it's actually 26% off out of the gates. And it's a four-filter system, totally game-changer. Find all about it at InfoWarsStore.com or call toll-free. We can answer all your questions as well, 888-253-3139. I'm your host, Alex Jones, and please, please spread our articles and videos. They're trying to censor us. They're coming after everybody's free speech right now. Use it or lose it. I know I gave the phone number out earlier, and I haven't gone to your calls. I did it 20 minutes ago, so I'm going to try to jam a few calls in at the start of the next segment. Folks want to talk about a lot of issues that are taking place. But I tell you, a social justice warrior from California says they disagree with everything, so I'm going to go to them first. And I might co-host a little bit into the next hour to finish these calls with David Knight. It tired me out, though, this morning to read over this EU document and actually see how horrible it is. I mean, it's not like, oh, gosh, this is horrible. This will discredit these people. I'll be proven right again. I'm like, oh, they're actually going to have Internet ID and tax it and shut down free speech. They're already doing it. And there's like almost no uproar. I mean, I am getting chills right now. I am really freaked out. And we need to be freaked out. That's normal, folks. This is horrible. Everybody else lives under tyranny in history. If you don't stand up, it's like not having a door on a submarine. It's going to flood. But these social justice warriors feel like they're part of the establishment. I'm going to go to social justice warrior in just a moment. But first, I got to play this because it's too important. Here's this war criminal Hillary about to give her new foreign policy speech that the news is covering, lecturing everyone when she says she failed in Libya and all these places. No, they wanted to make it a failed state. That's war crime. She's a horrible mass murderer, and she wants to say that Donald Trump's a bad guy. So here's Donald Trump responding. Yeah, it's the seven points. Donald Trump, I said when he went to break, top seven reasons why Hillary Clinton should never be elected president. Here it is.
She's not qualified because she has bad judgment. Now, who said that? Bernie Sanders said it about Hillary. She's not qualified. So here are 7 points that I marked down, which I think are important. And they talk about Hillary and her incompetence. She's one of the worst secretaries of state in the history of our country. Now she wants to be our president. Look, I'll be honest. She has no natural talent to be president. This is not a president. They talk about me. Actually, a lot of people think I look extremely presidential. You want to know the thing. But do you really believe that Hillary is presidential? This is not presidential material. Her Libya invasion, the Libya invasion was disgusting. I mean, you know who has the oil? ISIS has the oil from Libya. We went in, we knocked the hell out of Libya. We did all of the things with Gaddafi and all, we did great. She ends up with Benghazi. Remember the famous phone call? At 3 o'clock in the morning, she'll answer the call. Guess what? She was sleeping. She was sleeping baby. Don't wake me up.
She was quarterbacking.
Of course, she took the calls from her slimy friends, but she didn't take 500 to 600 calls. They were calling and calling, and she was sleeping, and she did that phony commercial. Remember that? That phony commercial, if the phone rings at 3 o'clock in the morning, well, it did ring a lot of times, and she was sleeping. Maybe it's no energy, low energy, right? She needed her sleep. She needed her sleep. So her Libya invasion, decisions on Syria, Iraq, and Iran have made the Middle East more dangerous than ever, ever before. And you know that.
All right, let's hit pause. That's only one or two of the points of the seven, but I've got to go to your calls. So we're going to come back. Some stations don't carry the fourth hour. A lot of stations are picking it up. I want to thank those affiliates for doing that. We have roundtable discussions. We have David Knight, Paul Watson, Jakari Jackson, Rob Dube, and so many other great reporters like Anthony Gucciardi and just countless others that hosted. That is coming up. The fourth hour, if your station doesn't carry it, Infowars.com/show to find all the free feeds. Please send that link out to everyone. This is a war. We need your help. I don't want to be in your New World Order hell. Look at the EU Commission. Merkel's threatening the UK not to leave. Merkel warns UK of isolation if Brexit camp wins vote. Talk about walking corpses, unholy living dead. Hillary's this low-energy goblin zombie. And you look at her followers. I mean, I'm sorry. I don't care what color they are. They look like a bunch of reanimated dead people. David Knight's coming up to haunt you the rest of the broadcast, the next segment. But I'll take calls. I'm going to stay with him and, you know, go for a while. I did a two-hour workout yesterday, and I did like an hour one this morning, and it killed me. And so when I'm low energy and struggling, I'm just going to keep going. That's the answer. Just keep going till you find the other side of that. But my low energy days are most people's high energy days. That's kind of bad for folks got to be around me all day, though. But stealth laws attack privacy and travel. That's coming up. Has Facebook become a black hat hacker? Absolutely. Newly disclosed CDC biolab failures, likely a screenplay for a disaster movie. Autonomous cars, smart highways, and the road to serfdom. La Raza. Groomed by globalists. We're going to get to all this coming up. But the big thing is the attack on free speech with the EU Commission that's unelected announcing what it's going to do. But let's talk to Social Justice Warrior. That's SJW from California to hear what they have to say. I'm told they disagree with everything. So go ahead. Are you able to talk? Can you talk?
Let's see if we can have a cogent conversation without you making ad hominem attacks.
There is no way you're a social justice warrior. You're actually able to talk. Is this a fake phone call?
We're already starting with your ad hominem attacks.
Okay, we're not in debate class, brother. Hillary gave the missile secrets to the communist Chinese. Okay, I mean, you support a traitor. Go ahead.
Stop, Alex.
Stop, Alex. Let me sound real smart. Go ahead. Tell me how the cow ate the cabbage.
I'm really honestly going to ask you a question. If you can stop talking for 25 seconds, I will send you $500.
Go ahead. Let's see what you have to say.
Start the clock, Alex. You know, Alex, one thing I've got to say to you is that you are part of the problem, not part of the solution. Clearly, you have gotten into bed with Fox News and Tucker Carlson and the Donald Trump camp and the Larry Nichols and the snake oil sales that you do. It's clearly an operation. What I'd like to ask you is, Alex, who are you really working for? Because you're clearly not working for the people.
Is that your 25 seconds? You had a couple seconds left. You talk about ad hominem attacks. You're not getting into politics or issues or any of it. There are a lot of people in a controlled media climate like Tucker Carlson who would get fired if he came out against the globalist over the years. And I've steadily seen him get better. So I want to win a war. And I've had dinner with him and know him personally, and he's a patriot. And he's done as much as he could, and he's getting better as liberty rises. I have had Fox News offer me multiple TV shows, multiple television programs, asked Mancal Muller and refused. And they couldn't believe it that I would not take them. So that's a fact. They want me to fly every weekend to New York and tape a show that'd be on Sunday. No way. Now, if they were here in Austin and I could say what I wanted, yeah, I'd be on Fox News. And I'd make the point that Fox is changing. We've won. You know, we've taken over. So I'm going to hold you over because I want to flesh this out with you, because we're going under world government. The EU is trying to censor people's speech. All this stuff's happening, and you make it about Alex Jones. Who am I oppressing? Who am I going after other than the classic leftist attack? I'm surprised you didn't throw in the Koch brothers. But now because they're openly against Trump, you can't say that. So, oh, he works for the Koch brothers. Really, I haven't seen one red cent from these people. So it's just all this pseudo-intellectual little bag of tricks. Oh, I've thrown in with the Bill of Rights, Buster. We'll be back. You know, my daughter, older daughter, she heard that like, you know, 6, 7, 8 years ago when she was little. And she goes, she'd already been reading, and she'd read some article in Texas Monthly about George Strait. And she goes, he sold more than the Beatles. What do you mean he doesn't have a dime, but what he's got is mine? And I said, sweetheart, he didn't write that song. It's about a rodeo out of San Antonio who doesn't have anything. And so that's not George Strait talking, but George Strait would probably tell you that all he's got is being an honorable, good person. I don't know folks that know George Strait. They say he's as good as it gets. And I could kick myself one time. I was invited to a birthday party that Ace in the Hole was playing at, and I didn't go. It's like 100 people. George Strait was there for 2 hours. I'm not a stalker, but I tell you, I really wanted to kick myself in the butt over that one. Okay, enough fanboy stuff about George Strait. But he does just live in between Austin and San Antonio. He's got a ranch out there and his family ranch south of Austin. The great part is he really comes from a ranching family, the whole nine yards, and is pure Americana. But you know what? I don't have a dime, but what I got is mine. I've got some money. I've got some money saved trying to run this operation for a while if they pulled everything out on us. I mean, I've got a backup, not much of one. But I understand what it means. I don't have a dime, but what I got is mine. All we have is our freedoms and our integrity and our ancestors and our children. And we're being robbed of that and being turned into a bunch of zombies. And that's what makes me angry. And I was talking to Social Justice Warrior, who's a rare, you know, if I just cared about ratings, because all I like to do is warn folks about the New World Order and kind of act like a honking goose half the time, repeating some of the same stuff. And I apologize, because the technocracy, the eugenicist, at the end of the day, what really matters other than the master plan? Hey, the folks running things are out to get us. and are really evil. And here they are, and let's do dossiers on each one, which we've done, from Soros right down the line. Then it doesn't matter what they're doing grassroots or how they spin it. You know somebody is evil who's in control. The devil is at the wheel. That's what I'm getting at. And I really believe in freedom. I really believe in private property and family and the Second Amendment, the right to follow whatever religion you want or not to. I'm a liberal. I'm a Thomas Jefferson lover. Again, I'm not gay, but I would marry the Bill of Rights. Is the Bill of Rights male, though? All right, I'm going to stop that joke. It's crazy. It's crazy to sit here and to know I'm genuine and to know I'm honorable and to know I'm true and to see the mainstream media, the globalists, the attack dogs, all of them, all they ever try to do is to say, I'm a fraud. When I was on the BBC like 3-4 years ago on their big Sunday morning show, biggest show in the country, I forget the name of it, it's what the big morning show is with the top host, and there was a member of Bilderberg at the meeting coming in next, and I blow up at him and say, this isn't a game, it's not a joke, they say I'm crazy. We go to break. They go, okay, get you leave. I stop yelling. They got security guards. They're about to grab me. And I walk out nicely. They go on air and they say, well, then I've videotaped the Bilderberg guy actually and have a conversation. But that was a minute later. Sorry. He was coming out of the bathroom. Look, you saw it on YouTube. So I started taping as soon as I left. In fact, thank God he went on air and lied like 3 minutes later after break and said that I had announced it's all fake. I don't mean any of this. I'm a fraud. Well, I started recording actually during the show. That's right. So I was still going. So we put that clip up on YouTube where you actually see me get up, them in my face, I leave, the Bilderberg guy's coming in, we get that on tape. I talked about this yesterday, how I tape these encounters so they can't set me up. And that's what they did with Katie Couric, so she couldn't set them up. See, people don't, we now know they're evil. We now don't just lay there and let the wolves attack. And once you get that mindset, it's game over. We'll kick their butt all day. And he got up on TV and he said, Alex Jones just said to us, he's a liar and he's a fake and doesn't mean any of it. And even the right-wing guy that was attacking me on there claiming, you know, because I don't want all these wars and I'm this big liberal, that was their attack over there. He wouldn't agree with the guy. He's like, isn't that true? The host said, the guy was like, and that's what they do. They say, you're not real. They call into doubt, hoping you're stupid, hoping that when they say Donald Trump said he hates Jews. I want to play that clip in a moment of those kids. I'm going to bring David Knight here in a moment. It's just, it's incredible. It's like, because they think you're dumb, they're just hoping you have doubt. Don't have any doubt. Donald Trump didn't say he hates Jews. Find the clip. Obama said it was free under Obamacare. And he said you could keep your doctor. That was all lies. And it doesn't matter what social justice warrior says. Okay? It doesn't matter. My family was, and I'm proud of this, literally at the heart of starting the Texas Revolution. On my mom's side. We raised Colonel Travis's son. I mean, on my dad's side, the Revolutionary War. Both sides of my family on the Mayflower. I'm so proud of my ancestors. They were just, almost all of them were just these awesome, super badass patriots. And you sit there and you call in and you tell me I'm not for real. And that I'm an operation. You don't make me sad because you attack my good name. You make me sad because you're such a dishonorable coward. And you're not going to win. You understand that? No matter what you do. I intend to win. We're going to take the country back. And our ideas will end up being on national television in the end. They're even saying that in the New York Times. They're panicking. Freedom trumps all your garbage all day. And I don't mean that as a pun. And I don't completely trust Trump. But he knows which way the wind's blowing. Bare minimum. And I think he's good at heart. You don't have to be perfect. But man, who wants to gut the country and make everybody poor? So you can all be equally miserable. So I want to go to Eric and Josh and Jeff and Chris and all of it. This guy, these people are always just saying he'll make statements about, let me talk, you're going to let me now, Alex, because he craves the control. So they want you poured under their control, so they dole out and tell their OCD, and they tell you how everything runs. Don't tell me how to behave. Don't tell me what to do. Don't do all your little OCD clicks and ticks. Just make your counter statements for 60 seconds or longer if you'd like. Mr. Social Justice Warrior, go ahead.
3 hours of you talking about the fake left-right paradigm, followed by 10 minutes of commercials, richmoney.rich.com, snake oil commercials, products that I've ordered that don't work. You are the epitome, Mr. Jones, of a charlatan. You're leading, you're actually leading sheep to the chessboard. That's all you're doing. And now that you've really shown your true colors by climbing into bed with the likes of people like, oh, let's see, Donald Trump, Larry Nichols, et cetera, you have shown your hand to be what you are, Alex, a true fraudster. You're just in it for the money. I mean, your whole staging, your whole marketing, your whole presentation with your suits and you're just, you know, all of the money that you've made it on the ignorance of the audience that tunes into you every day.
All right.
And you say this.
I'm going to respond to you now. You talk for 1 minute. You understand how local affiliates and radio works. There are network ads. There are local ads. There are syndication ads. There's like four or five different types of ads, depending on how you're listening. Okay. So I hear that ad you mentioned all over national radio. It's a national buy. It's on the network. And I have been offered those type of sponsors. I don't take them. When you hear it, it's my voice or one of my reporters. And I absolutely love X2. When I'm having allergies or coughing, I mean, Lung Cleanse works great for me. On third-party sites, it's got five-star reviews by the hundreds and hundreds. So absolutely, I am proud that we open up a shop to promote freedom and fund ourselves. Then they sent founding fathers over to France and sit there at parties and beg and sell little American flags, you know, try to get money for the revolution. Most revolutionaries, you know, rob banks and stuff. And some revolutions, people have their wives whore out, and people see that as honorable. In some revolutions, I wouldn't do that. So, you know, we're not having our wives at a brothel to fund this. We're not robbing banks. We're like selling air purifiers and water purifiers that if you're not using, you're nuts, that I personally use. I'm going to skip this network break here. And you don't say where my politics are wrong. Larry Nichols is scum. Larry Nichols, if you don't know who he is, never talks about it. I know people that were in the military at the time. He was a Green Beret officer who fought communists all over Latin America and Africa and was highly decorated and was sent by the CIA to basically be embedded with the Clintons because Clinton was CIA and prepare him for the governorship. And that guy, when the Clintons started killing kids, he went public and they tried to kill him. And you know, the guy, it's like Christ on the cross and he's got, you know, the thief and the murderer beside him. I forget which one it is. And, you know, one of them apologizes and repents and God felt it and said, you'll be with me in paradise tonight. And you sit there with Larry Nichols calling him a charlatan when I happen to know that there have been times when he's supposed to be on the show and he is, they're there with defibrillators. That guy has been died. Okay. He didn't want us to talk about it. I am. That guy has been dying lately and they're in there defibrillating him to get back up and fight. And you sit there and you call him a wimp when you're nothing. I don't know what your problem is. I don't know what your deal is, but I'm sick of it. You sit there and you say someone that's challenged the Clinton crime machine is a piece of filth. I'm gonna ask questions. Do you, Social Justice Warrior, do you support Hillary Rodham Clinton? Because you don't like people that don't like her.
How long are you going to support the Jewish Zionist paradigm, Alex?
Oh, my God. The total. Go ahead. Tell me about the Jews. Go ahead. You have 60 seconds.
How long are you going to hide behind the 10,000-pound elephant in the room? When are you going to talk about, instead of calling people globalist, Alex, why don't you spell it out for your audience? It's Jewish Zionists. David Duke handed your ass in a can, and you did all, the only thing that you did was sit there and try to derail this man, as you've tried to derail me now, and as you've tried to insinuate that I just called Larry Nichols a charlatan. I called you specifically a charlatan, Mr. Jones.
No, you said bad people like Larry Nichols. Oh, hold on. Stop right there. Stop right there. I went and interviewed Louis Farrakhan to really try to have a real interview, and he was genuine and real, even though I don't agree with some of the things he said, and so he talked 90% of the time. David Duke, we timed it out, talked almost 70% of the time and bitched and whined the whole time that I wasn't letting him talk when I was trying to bring up eugenics and how we're all being targeted by this, things like Gardasil. And he didn't want that, okay? And so he didn't want access to my audience to try to have a real discussion, or his supporters didn't. And, man, I have people tell me I'm Jewish and that I get orders from Israel and that I get Jewish money, and none of it's true. And you act like you're on some high and mighty, or the Koch brothers, or the Catholic Church. I've had all these mentally ill groups. I fund myself selling products and having a few sponsors that are mine and that I endorse. It's just crazy that there are a lot of black people that have been brainwashed and are racist and weird who hate me. I don't hate other black people because some black people are weird. There are a lot of weird white people that hate me. I mean, I'm so hated by the white supremacist people because they're so government connected and run. That's come out so many times because they want to brand the anti-globalism movement as anti-black, anti-Hispanic, anti-Jew. And that's a management tactic by the big media to make it all that. Is there a Jewish mafia that's involved in it, heavily involved, commanding many parts of it, like Sumner Redstone? Absolutely. And I just come in and say globalism attacks everybody, and we should come together against it. And most Jews aren't part of the Jewish mafia, and there's all sorts of other mafias involved. This is a eugenics, scientific technocracy system at the top. It uses all these other paradigms of management. And so I'm my own person. And so I choose not to bash Protestants, Catholics, Jews, anybody. The Pope comes out and says Christ, you know, was like ISIS and we should be ashamed of our Christian roots. Or I think he said horrified by it or whatever it was. And I'm like, that is an anti-Christian statement. This man is evil. By his own words, he is blasphemous, okay? I love Catholics. They're good people. I love the Jews I know in my life. My whole life have just been really smart, cool people. My dad has friends, you know. One guy's a geologist. Friend from college. We went on these long geology trips when I was a kid in Big Bend and Texas and Arizona, and just really smart and cool and nice and cared about, you know, all I've ever had is Jews I knew that were nice and were actually there and intellectual and wanted to help me. Okay, then I see these evil people that happen to be Jewish up there. Those people that sold out, you know, somebody like Alan Greenspan was like a Ron Paul in the 60s and 70s. He was writing books. He was writing white papers about the Federal Reserve and how it was private and evil and go back to gold or the New World Order. They bought him out like Anakin Skywalker, and he became Darth Vader. So, again, it's just crazy. It's like Italians. It's like, I'm not going to hire Italians because there's an Italian mafia and, you know, 0.1% of Italians are in a mafia. It's idiotic. I made a film I produced called Fabled Enemies about criminal elements of Israel and their involvement in 9/11 that was the most hardcore out there, and it made the Jew haters 50 times madder. I made a film, Terror Storm, that had a section on Gulf of Tonkin, but also a section on a bunch of other false flags, like the USS Liberty. It made the Jew haters just see. They said, no one else does false flags, Jews. No, there's evil Jews, there's good Jews. There's good Germans, there's bad Germans. There's good Chinese, there's bad Chinese. There's good Mexicans, there's bad Mexicans. You judge a tree by its fruits, and you guys just fall back because you're better than anybody. You can just say someone works for the Jews and sit back and be moral and be superior, like a social justice warrior, that you're just like them. That's why you called yourself that today. You didn't say, I am a person that believes in a Jewish conspiracy. You'd have been put on air. We let you guys on. We don't screen your calls. But you said you were a social justice warrior. And out of their mouths, out of the mouths of babes, you will hear truth. You're right. They're just like, they show up and they scream, you're a racist. You hate Mexicans, or white guy. You hate Jews, like these little Jewish kids saying that Donald Trump hates Jews. It's the exact same thing. You can't even see it. You're not an intellectual. You're a pseudo-intellectual who lines up these things that makes you feel like you've got all the answers. I mean, you can sit there and read all these things about Jews running this and Jews running that, and then just project it onto Jews as if they weren't there, your whole world would be okay. Sumner Redstone hates the fact that I attack him for his anti-family activities, and don't point out that he is a super hardcore racist Jew. But old-fashioned Judaism was just like every other group saying our group's the best, everybody else is filth. That's tribalism. But I don't dislike Sumner Redstone because he's an old Jewish guy. I dislike him because he's anti-human. See, this is the spirit of the people we face, not their cover. And you think you're looking deeper, you're not. And all these anti-Semitic people that are into all this stuff, I know they overproject that and demonize, and the Israeli lobby's out of control. I cover it all. I talk about the Chinese lobby, the Saudi Arabian lobby, the Israeli lobby being out of control. Stop trying to run our country. And they go, you piece of filth, Jones. He was covering up for the Jews today when he talked about Israel and their lobby and how it's a little out of control. No, it's all out of control, Alex. So, look, it's about you being in the winning club. You're the purist. You're the good man. So just say goodnight to the bad guy. Go ahead. Tell me I work for the Jews. Go ahead, social justice warrior. Get yourself a gold star over at Stormfront.
Unbelievable. It's unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
You spent 10 minutes, and you don't give the caller a chance to even interject.
To spew some more false allegations? You're the ones making the allegations. God. You're not worried about the New World Order. You're worried I'm working for the Jews over here because I'm promoting free market and family and Second Amendment and religious rights and sovereignty. Oh, my God, I'm so bad. What is it I'm doing that's bad? Tell me what I'm doing that isn't promoting freedom. Tell me, other than I work for the Jews. Tell me. I'm waiting.
You're not.
The truth is, I have the Jewish lobby constantly attacking me my whole career. That's the truth. But you're over here saying I work for these people, so explain it to me. Go ahead. Explain it to me right now.
You have Jewish lobbies attacking you, Alex? For goodness sakes, give me a darn break. What you're doing is trying to obfuscate and confuse your
globalist lobbies. There's lots of lobbies. What do you mean? The fact is, the mainstream media attacks me, calls me anti-Semitic. Okay, I'm done talking to you. I mean, you just hear that guy. He listens to his own voice. Just give me a break, Alex.
I got to chime in here real quick.
Go ahead, John. Yeah. I'm going to bring it. And by the way, David Knight doesn't mind. He knows doing the fourth hour. Some days I take over. He loves it. Everyone's like, hey, we were returning to hear David Knight or Paul Watson. What are you doing taking over? I can do a fourth hour every day. I don't have the energy every day. These guys are smarter than I am in many respects, so we all augment each other. Just like some days I can't do the show. He does the whole show. So David is good. Right, David? I don't even know if he's still in the studio in there. David, you ready to come in?
Yeah, I can't bear to listen to people like that. You know, trolls.
Oh, so you'd left the room. I'm sorry.
No, I'm here. I'm here. Can you hear me?
Well, you're awesome, but explain to folks that I'm not, like, meanly taking over the show. You know that, right?
That's right. And I've worked for Alex for 4 years. I know what Alex is, and I know he's not a sellout. He is totally in this. I wouldn't even be here if you weren't in the fight for liberty, Alex, and pouring everything that you get back into this operation. Not because you want to make money. When we had the attack at Sandy Hook, you were shutting down commercials, skipping commercial breaks left and right, not plugging anything that you sell, not letting any other commercials on.
Because I can't
help that information out. Exactly. I've watched you for 4 years, and I don't really have any patience to listen to these David Duke Nazis. I'm from the South. I've heard the Ku Klux Klan before. They're full of it, and I don't have the time to listen to
these guys. I agree. Let's come back and talk about it. And then John, and I've never seen John Harmon want to just jump in randomly up in Minnesota, so let's hear from him. Yeah, no, I've been at the Dairy Queen when I'm 16 with a cute local girl and had guys pull in with four trucks and get out and go, we're going to beat your butt, Yankee, because you're with a good-looking girl, and we're in a county that my family basically founded.
Yeah.
A bunch of
we're
scum.
We're on the march.
I'll tell you what it is about all these weird camps, and Larry Nichols was talking about this earlier when he was on about how to defeat the globalists. We got to come together around basic sovereignty, basic free market, basic rights, due process. And he said, well, there's all these groups that want to bully you into being into their little pet project. And I mean, I'm just like, I remember like, it's like 13 years ago, I get a call, then an email, and it's like, you will expose the Black Pope and that the Jesuits run everything, or we will expose you as a coadjutor or something. And I was just like, who the hell's this? I'm like, I'll never interview that person threatening me like that. And they're like, look, Alex Jones is a Jesuit. And it was some black guy named Alex Jones. They were like passing links around. They're like, respond to the fact that you're a Jesuit preacher. And I'm like, no, I'm a Protestant. And that's a black guy named Alex Jones. You people are crazy. Oh, you're not going to interview us now as we expose you as a Jesuit. And I'm just like, what on earth are you people smoking? Then they're like, what? You're not saying the Catholic Church isn't corrupt? And I'm like, no, more and more it's promoting globalism. It's being infiltrated, being taken over, all the pedophiles, the rest of it. I said, I really just want to promote freedom and try to audit the Federal Reserve and get our country back. But, yeah, that isn't enough. We know you're working with them. They, like, glue my head on top of women and say, Alex Jones is a tranny. Here's the proof. I mean, just blasphemous, false witness stuff. But I got to be honest, you know, the Catholics run it all, crowd. They don't have anything on the anti-Jew crowd. And it's just a big diversion from everything. It's a total diversion. Is there a Jewish mafia at the highest levels of the New World Order? Absolutely. Do the Rothschilds end up taking over Europe and the Napoleonic Wars? They funded both sides? Absolutely. Totally true. There's also all sorts of weird, bizarre eugenics, Germanic death cults at the highest level. It's just bad stuff. It's bad stuff. You can call it whatever name you want, but it's like they got this big magic. Oh, I got on air. Jews, Jews. You won't say Jews. And I'm like, did we screen your call? No. Okay. You know. Well, you're one of them. And it's just like, no, I'm legitimate in that I'm really doing what I think's best and telling the truth here. But they think they get a big score when they make it about race, just like social justice warriors. Now, I apologize to Josh and Jeff and Chris and Eric. I'm going to get to you and then let our normal host in the fourth hour of this day, David Knight, take over. But David, John Harmon wants to pop in, too, up there in Minnesota running the board. But let's get your take on this, then a few calls, and I'm going to get Harmon in here, and we're going to punch out.
You know, one of the things I was going to talk about today, Alex, was the talking points that are being done, not only by the Democrats. We've got Hillary Clinton coming out against Donald Trump saying his foreign policy positions are dangerous. Of course, John Kerry is doing the same thing. Say foreign policy is not a business deal, okay? There's also another fellow skull and bones man who is now running for high office, and that's William Weld, who got the VP nomination with the Libertarian Party. And as we look at these people, John Kerry, William Weld, Hillary Clinton, they're globalists. They're not Jews, okay? When you look at William Weld, he is part of the Harvard royalty. His ancestor was one of the first graduating class of 1650. He's had 18 generations of Harvard men. Two buildings are named after him, okay? Those people, however, are coming after our freedoms. He's out saying he sees absolutely nothing criminal in Hillary Clinton's emails. This is a New York Times article. And even the New York Times says his comments could inflame criticism that William Weld is a de facto stalking horse for Clinton in order to win the nomination. That's what we're seeing, Alex. We're seeing that if we look at what he's been saying about NAFTA, about what they've been saying about, he was actually
part. Yeah, the headline is globalists take over the Libertarian Party. It's happened.
Yes, yes. And that's the whole thing. We've had at
the top. And by the way, Gary Johnson showing himself as a total sleeper cell operative.
Yes, at the top of the Republican and the Democrat parties, we've mentioned so many times, it is a single party, and they are working towards globalism. They have a common goal. If you look at the elitists in the Republican Party that hate Donald Trump so much, why is it? It's because it's nationalism versus globalism. And now we see these globalists have now taken over and assimilated into the Borg, the Libertarian Party. That's why I'm so concerned about that. It used to be a party that stood for individual liberty. Now it stands for globalism. Actually, coming out and saying there's absolutely nothing criminal in Hillary Clinton's email use. Really? Seriously? I mean, can anybody truly believe that? I mean, Camille Paglia doesn't believe it. Nobody who looks at this, even if they have a different political view than we do, even Democrats don't believe that Hillary Clinton's emails are legitimate.
Oh, yeah. The libertarians always get ignored. They've done a great job overall. Yeah. I've been one in intellectual alliance, not in the party itself, in its whole apparatus. And now that the system might want to use them as a spoiler, they're like, oh, be part of us. Join us. Oh, please let us be part of the establishment.
Yeah.
While the establishment sinks into obscurity and begins its decadent implosion. Now, bringing John Harmon in, you're absolutely right. You talk about a Harvard mafia.
Yeah.
Saudi Arabian mafia. Chinese mafia. There's all these big special interests, all of them. I don't want special interests running my life. And almost all these special interests work together to have tyrannical control because they want a centralized system of levers they control to get more power. That's why they all behave the same. I don't care if it's Chinese or Jewish or Saudi Arabian. I abhor all of these lobbies that are centralizing control. These are just corrupt interests from all these different countries and groups. And that's how they control us, is in divide and conquer, always saying it's one group or the other is the problem. If you just got rid of this group, that'd fix everything, instead of having a moral, informed, involved populist that is allowed to engage in free association. Then the best music, the best art, the best science, the best culture, whether it's Jimi Hendrix or whether it's Ludwig von Beethoven, will rise to the top. Whether it's a deaf German man or a young black man who was in Vietnam, their art will rise to the top because the human spirit resonates with it. And political correctness is, whether it's Nazi or whether it's social justice warrior, is about orthodoxy under one stricture code thought. And then if you just eradicate some group racially, then you'll have total power and total control in this great, wonderful heaven. Now, I want to go to Josh and Eric and Jeff and Chris, but and then hand the baton briefly to finish up the broadcast today. But Knight is making great points here today in overdrive here in the fourth hour. Let's now go to John Harmon, who I rarely hear jump in. I mean, it might be once a year. I tell him, come on, my good friend of 15 years, John Harmon up there. John, you wanted to pop in about this guy.
Absolutely. I was just chomping at the bit because a lot of these callers that call in and they're, quote, you know, haters, disagree with you. He called in, said he disagreed with everything, didn't make one point about actually disagreeing with a specific topic. They always do that. They always make it about you and that you're owned and bought and paid for, that you are bad for making money. They don't know the difference between network, local ads, and, you know, national ads. It's just, you know, we gave him plenty of time. He didn't say anything, and he didn't actually make one point. He just attacked your guests. He attacked you,
Then he said he didn't attack Nichols.
Yeah, and then he claimed he didn't do that. But you can always tell. There's a tell with these guys is because they always attack the messenger. They never attack the information. I mean, bottom line, he could sit on air for a whole hour. He would just sit
and really, it's all about how, in his mother's basement, he's a bigger man than me.
Exactly. And he's like, hey, guys, can you believe this guy? Can you believe this guy? As if he's talking to a crowd of people, because he's applying to those, that small crowd out there.
Yeah, he wants to go over to some website and have them go, look at Bobby or whatever his name is. He did a really good job. Yeah, my education really on the Ku Klux Klan was just another gang, just a group of thugs come up and threaten you. And they can't believe when you say, all right, let's go right now. Same thing with black racist gangs, you know, would start to fight with me. I was like, boy, this, you know, want me to be your huckleberry? I'm ready. I can't handle it. I freak out. I panic forward and attack you like an insane creature. When I'm surrounded by overwhelming odds, I go nuts. And these people just don't get it. I'm not here to be bullied by you anymore. It's over. Whether you're a black group or a KKK, go to hell. I'm done. Period. And you don't intimidate me. Hillary does it. None of them do. I don't care what you do to me. I can't help it. I'm coming for you, period.
And just like David was saying, he's known you for, I think you said 4 years. I've known you for about 15 years. You're totally independent. You know, I've never seen you take money from some shady outfit or anything. I mean,
you've heard Rothkopf totally, of the Kissinger Group, yep, offer me to go to D.C.
Trying to recruit you. And you just, nope. You're your own man. You're just a guy on the radio trying to figure it out just like everyone else. So everyone calling in.
Well, God bless you, John, for that. But the point is that so are you and so are most people. There are good people. We just never get in a position. But the Internet's allowed normal people to get a position. There's lots of people like me or you or David Knight. David Knight, you know, has been watching the show for a decade. He's been here for 4 years. He didn't even win the contest. But when we did reporter hiring, he you know, he's done a great job. He's here. Moved his family here. I'm so honored by it. But again, exactly. Change the subject away from the topics. Hey, they're trying to start an internet ID and tax the internet and restrict speech. Here's the document. Let's stop it. Shut up. You're working for the Jews. And I'm just like, okay, let's just say I work for them so you can feel official and powerful. Can we move on and defend free speech now? Thank you, John Harmon, for your great points. Let's go back to David Knight, and then I'm going to go these calls. David?
Yeah, Alex, that's a hallmark of the federal trolls, you know, when they come in and they make it about silly side issues like that. He really doesn't have anything to say. And as I pointed out, I grew up in the South. I've seen that kind of nonsense before, and I just don't even want to talk about that. There's so much that we need to talk about.
You grew up in the South. Okay. Did you ever have the Klan come up because you were at a dance with a good-looking girl or something and get in your face?
No, they never bothered me, but I've seen the way they operate, and I don't have any patience for it, and I don't even want to talk about it. And, of course, he starts out by saying, well, I know you're going to attack me ad hominem, and mentions that several times, and all he does is an ad hominem attack on you. He doesn't talk about any issues. We can talk about issues. I've been talking about issues with the Libertarian Party. You talked about how, you know, we've been libertarian. We agree with liberty. We want to hold that up as the most important thing that is out there. I actually worked in the Libertarian Party. I hate to see things that I worked toward being taken over by the globalist establishment. And that's what's going on here. We had Gary Johnson say, hey, I want Weld because he's connected. You're darn right he's connected. He's connected to the globalists, to the Northeast establishment globalists. And we got a lot of evidence about this.
Well, I've had Johnson in studio. I've interviewed for many years. And he creeps me out bad. He's very robotic, very chameleon. I don't ever want Gary Johnson back on again, quite frankly. Because I don't want to just get his money on because, oh, it's a newsmaking. I don't want to be around it.
Well, the problem I had with him when he was running 4 years ago was the issues that he chose. He chose to put at the forefront of his campaign abortion and gay marriage. Now, those are not issues that all libertarians agree upon. Okay, a lot of there's still a lot of disagreement.
It's a football issue. It's a state issue.
Exactly. And he made those, when you say marriage, a libertarian position is the government shouldn't be involved in marriage, not promoting or pushing anything. But now he's gone even farther, saying that you ought to be able to put small business bakers out of business so they don't bake the cake for your gay wedding. And then in the debate, they put it a different way. They said, should Nazis be able to force Jewish bakers to make a Nazi cake? Why, certainly. He has no respect for private property. He has no understanding of where you draw the line when rights collide, and he wants to use government as a coercive nature, okay?
Absolutely. This is breaking, David. And again, this is going to happen as he dominates and they're forced to do it. But Paul Ryan says he's voting for Donald Trump. Donald Trump looks like an evil toad in that photo. I don't mean that meanly. I look like a toad too, but man, he looks like a toad. But I'm going to be watching Trump, and if he starts going sideways, folks, I'm going to, you know, expose it, but I want to be politically there in the center covering it, not part of the system, but in the center of it so I can surveil it all and really be able to credibly cover what's happening and unfolding with Trump. But my gut tells me Trump is overall good and a nationalist, even though he can go in the white horse direction, you know, of a little bit of a Napoleonic issue. I don't mean because he's short. He's not short. But, you know, he's got some problems. But
yeah,
he scares them in the calculus,
yeah,
because he is a nationalist and he doesn't want to wreck the country. I mean, he just isn't out
promoted,
to get us.
He's promoted some authoritarian ideas, that's for sure. But I believe this is about the issue of nationalism versus globalism, because if you lose the nationalism, you lose your Bill of Rights, you lose your
constitution, your command base, you lose your country, yes, you're screwed, because you know the globalists. It's like a spaceship.
And the founders of this country and libertarians have always understood that the antithesis to individual liberty is state control, and it's harder to control it as it gets farther and larger.
Exactly. Our whole Declaration of Independence is about that.
Exactly.
Let's go to Josh in Texas. Josh, you're on the air with David Knight. Go ahead.
Mr. Jones, Mr. Knight, pleasure to be on air with you all, long-time listener, first-time caller. Just to touch base real quick on the last caller, I mean, people who, you know, try and criticize y'all for selling products and stuff, I mean, how are you supposed to fund, you know, a huge operation like that? Are you supposed to sell dinner plates? I mean, give me a break.
Well, the Nazis are national socialists. So.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I think y'all do a great job. I really appreciate it.
Well, absolutely. I mean, I started out 21 years ago as an Access TV host, and then I have sat there and just slowly funded and ratcheted up our resistance. And notice, for the bang for the buck, we just now have stratospheric success. And so I have a responsibility. I don't want to grow this place, but I've got to. I've got to do the full resistance, or my bones won't let me do it. I mean, do people get that? I cannot back down. I just, my gut, my heart, my spirit says, you will take on the New World Order. You will interview the guests that are dangerous. You will go out in public with no security. You will be aggressive. You will do this. And so I'm doing it. But again, we've changed the subject, not to internet censorship you're calling in about, but to Alex Jones. Okay, Alex Jones goes to Timbuktu tomorrow, okay? Or I, you know, die in a freak ballooning accident or whatever, randomly, hypothetically. Whatever. A meteorite hits me. What about the internet censorship? What about them coming after us? Go ahead, Josh.
Okay, so I just want to share a story with the audience. You know, a story that I just got from my buddy on Tuesday a couple of days ago. And, you know, I was completely unaware this kind of stuff was going on. I'm assuming a lot of the audiences as well. I'll just jump right in. My buddy told me that, you know, he'd spent all day on the phone with his cable provider. Basically, what he did was he downloaded a torrent file, and the cable, the probably the production companies, you know, like Sony, all these, you know, big production companies, you know, they tracked his IP address down to where he lives. He got an email from AT&T saying that his, you know, service was cut off. They apparently had sent the email to an email address that wasn't associated with the account, so he had no idea his internet was just cut off.
Sure. Let's go further. They're now making multinational agreements. This is all admitted. Remember, John McCain wanted to be able to blow your computer up by remote, fry it, about 10 years ago. And, yeah, that's what this whole TPP that we couldn't see does. So now it's censorship, it's control. You can argue piracy's wrong. I tend to think, you know, at certain levels it's out of control. But, hey, whatever. Now they're remotely watching you. No judge, no jury. They're turning your service off. Lawyers sometimes send us letters and say, your IP downloaded this. And it turns out, you know, we didn't. I tell the lawyer go to hell when they ask for $10,000. But yes, this is part, I'm going to skip this break. This is so important. This is exactly what we're talking about, David, that this is here. They're launching the takeover of the internet now. Whatever arguments they have, side issue. The globalists are launching the end of free speech now. And that tells me they're getting ready to drop the hammer on a bunch of other issues, David.
Yeah, Alex, you know, we can see this coming. Yesterday, I was talking about how the laws, there was this expose, an article on Drudge, talking about how Congress is passing secret laws. Well, we've talked for the longest time how we've got the Star Chamber Court and the FISA Court that does these dragnet surveillance orders, also says that they're secretly amending the Constitution. We find out then that the Congress is writing secret laws that we can't even see. And then we have now the UN is going to be directly setting laws. We've had UN agendas like UN Agenda 21, which they've now renamed as the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. Okay, Agenda 21, it's easier to say. We still talk about it that way. The war on drugs was a UN agenda back in 1961. They created the four schedules and put all the drugs into those four schedules 10 years before Richard Nixon copied that agenda verbatim from the UN and said, this is our war on drugs. He didn't invent that. That was a UN agenda. But now in Europe, they are putting in UN laws, and you've got British newspapers saying, finally, we're going to have self-driving cars because the UN has got a bunch of new laws. They're going to directly enact these laws.
Absolutely. They're putting laws in place to make you have robot drivers, to make you have smart meters, and then the corporations get the money from it. That's how the market works now. We've got to educate the public. Josh, so again, have your friend send us a copy of it. We'll black out his name if you want. We'll do a report on that. But yes, I'm aware of that going on. Go ahead.
Also, you know, I'm not condoning or supporting torrent downloading. You know, that's a whole debate in itself. I'm not getting into that.
The point is they want to shut it all down and surveil it without warrants to shut our legal and lawful stuff down that's on those as well. Go ahead.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, I just feel like this is, you know, the slow incremental rollout of, you know, the censorship, the policing of the internet. And to basically what they did was, they gave him a packet. First of all, his internet shut off. They tell him that he has to take a test, and he has to, you know, they give him like a packet of 20 to 30 pages material, and they give him like a 20-40 question test, and they give you the test, and you have to take that test before you can get your service turned back on. Now, through your contract, you still have to pay your service every month, you know, everything. I mean, there's no judge, there's no jury. You know, you have to take this test. He actually said that he didn't pass it, that he got, you know, a 40 out of 100 on it. And, you know, still, so apparently, you know, he said he doesn't think that it matters, the score you get, but, you know, it's just.
Well, that's what they're announcing in China and Europe is an internet and basically cyber score index. No one's debating it. No one's discussing it. It's been planned. It's being rolled out.
And, Alex, it's part of the trade partnerships that they're putting in, the TPP, the Trans-Pacific, also the Transatlantic Partnership. A key part of that is control of the internet. And just this last week, we had Obama in Vietnam with two young Hispanic legislators from Texas. One of them, one of the Castro twins, and you know all about the Castro twins. This was the congressman who supported the Trade Promotion Authority, the TPA, to speed these agreements through Congress. And of course, the other twin brother has been promoted as Hillary Clinton's vice presidential pick. He's the guy who's currently Secretary of HUD. And the feds. But these two guys, you want to talk about mafia, you want to talk about racism. These two guys are the spawn of an Hispanic activist who was one of the founders of La Raza. This is like
well, a Bill Ayers. And again, to the Klan, they sound good to themselves.
Yeah.
And to La Raza and Mecha, they sound reasonable, but it's the exact same stuff, just different group of people. Let's go ahead. Thank you, Josh. What do we call this just for YouTube, this little last 10 minutes with them? Because I know this is going on. It's been in the news. What do we say? AT&T spying on customers' downloads? I mean, that's what's going on. Shutting off their service? Boom. Let's talk to John in Colorado. Saw this jet crash and a fighter pilot testing thing, and he didn't get killed. That's good news. And we'll go to him if we have time. But see who's been holding the longest. Chris in Georgia, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, how are you?
I'm all right. I'm sorry I had to hold so long. Your phone's hissing. Go ahead.
You're fine. The caller who said you were a Zionist is playing that bullshit. He's probably just jealous of you. But my question, and it's a statement before a question. I got a couple of questions, but let me get started.
Sure, but haters going to hate. Yeah.
Sir?
No, haters going to hate. That's what the guy's doing. Go ahead.
Yes. It said that the UN and our military would take guns this year through martial law because the Constitution would be suspended under martial law. So my question to you is, do you think we, the people, would win, or do you think the New World Order will rise and we will be defeated?
I'm going to jump off because your phone's breaking up, but it's an excellent question. It doesn't matter if they claim they have it on paper that they can barbecue kids on the White House lawn, hypothetically. Just because they say it's martial law, military take the guns, the military is not going to follow that order. So I think there's some missing links here in the globalist equation. David Knight?
Yeah, Alex, I don't know exactly how this is going to shake out. I find it very disturbing, this article that came out of the Philippines, where you've got the new president there saying he's okay with killing journalists because, you know, if you're an SOB, he can kill you. And it's one of the most dangerous places for journalists to be. But we ought to understand that. You know, remember that movie that we went to see, The Act of Killing, where they were talking about what happened in Malaysia? We haven't heard too much about that.
I got physically sick after I watched that.
Yes. And for the people who haven't seen that, these are a bunch of people who, and this was Obama's father was part of this administration in Malaysia. They were being, they were partnering with the CIA. We haven't heard about that story in Indonesia because these people are allies of the American government, so they haven't really talked about that in America. But you had these guys who had executed so many people and were bragging about how they would do these mass executions of people. And when I saw this guy in the Philippines, this new president, talking about how he would kill journalists if he didn't like them, and he's attacked bishops, called them sons of whores, so forth and so on. This guy, when I saw that, Alex, it reminded me of that movie. That's what I thought of. And that's, we are so close to that because we've got a president who grew up in Indonesia where they were doing that, where they, you know, he grew up in that culture.
Oh, you're right. Folks have no idea how much trouble we're in. You know, I really hogged the airwaves today. I apologize to all these other callers, Eric and Jeff and Garrett and John. If you call me back tomorrow, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., I promise I'll go to your calls within 5-10 minutes. In fact, everybody on hold, if you want to give us your name and address, and the size, I'm going to send you a Hillary for Prison t-shirt, absolutely free, limited edition from InfoWarsStore.com. So please, Jono, that's more work for you guys, but get their names and addresses and their sizes. They can either have a Hillary for Prison or a Come and Take It shirt. And I didn't plug, and I skipped two breaks this hour, and I think five or six today. It's got to stop. There I'm saying, I need money to fund the operation, but they'll skip the breaks because I get so excited, so passionate. You need to go to InfoWarsStore.com. We have the new Alexa Pure Breeze air filter that's amazing. The Alexa Pure and Pro Pure water filters are excellent. We have Lung Cleanse, 20% off, limited time only. That's been going all day. That's only for a few days. I should have plugged that. Lung Cleanse is amazing. Experience that if you have allergies or other issues. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com for the nutraceuticals, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And your purchase of these products is essential. Sign up for auto shipping at 10% off. And get 50 free shipping on orders of $50 or more. So many specials. Check them all out. Sign up for the free newsletter so we can stay in contact. Infowars.com/newsletter. David, thanks for letting me hijack the fourth hour, buddy.
No problem, Alex.
All right, nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock Central. And Paul Watson's doing a special Reddit deal. Infowars.com for details.